Howdy, partners. Yeah, I said that. Welcome to the Mountain West Championship game between the Aztecs of San Diego State and, of course, the Cowboys of Wyoming.
It's great to see you two city slickers on a horse. You look like Billy Crystal.
Right? Thank you.
This should be a great game between these two teams. 2 weeks ago, a 34-33 thriller.
Donnell Pumphrey, great running back prospect. Don't know if I'm more excited to see him or to get off this horse, which, by the way, is now starting to move.
You should see what the horse is doing behind you. With McShay and Tex, I'm Levy. Saddle up with us for the next 3.5 hours. It's going to be great.
That was great.
Welcome to ESPN College Football Primetime, presented by Hampton by Hilton, part of Jimmy V Week for Cancer Research, as we continue our commitment to the V Foundation, Jim Valvano's dream to defeat cancer. All week it's been hashtag pack the war, and here come the Cowboys of Wyoming. Their perfect home regular season for the first time in some 20 years. Now trying to win a conference title outright for the first time since 1988. And the visitors are the Aztecs of San Diego, who are trying to win the conference title for a second consecutive year, third in 5 years, trying to win a 21st conference title in school history. Let's get this out of the way right now. It's a little chilly. Not gonna lie to you. We've got it at 18 degrees, 10 mile per hour winds, and I don't want to hear anything from the kids from San Diego State. If they would have won a week ago, this game could be played there, where it is currently 60 degrees. And with that, we welcome you inside the broadcast booth here at the War Memorial. And I can't believe you made me wear
this
green suit.
Yes, you look great.
Yeah, you fit right in, and I look ridiculous.
Wait a minute. Before we go any further.
Oh, really?
We got to get the hat on the right way. I mean, come on, let's do it right.
You set me up so bad. This is the biggest home game for Wyoming in their 120-year history as championship Saturday continues on. Yep. For the Mountain West Championship game, it is the top-ranked offense against the top-ranked defense. The oddity here is these two teams played right here just 2 weeks ago. Wyoming was able to win by a single point in the thriller.
It was a great game, 34-33. Both teams went back and forth, came down to a two-point play. Antonio Hull was able to knock it down, and Wyoming got the win.
How ridiculous do I really look right now?
You look beautiful. I mean, from Long Island to Laramie, I think he looks pretty good, don't you?
Aren't you from South Florida? What is going on? Donnell Pumphrey is clearly the big star here. He told us yesterday, each of the last 2 weeks, he thought about the Heisman, thought about the trip to New York. He failed to break 100 yards in either of those two games. He's no longer thinking about the Heisman.
Well, certainly he's going to, as San Diego State goes, so goes Donnell Humphrey. He's got to have a big game. He has to get yards in between the tackles. We know he's a good player outside the tackles, but Steve, the only player in the history of college football with 5,000 yards rushing and over 1,000 yards receiving. Most people sleep on this skill right here, out of the backfield, making guys miss. They're going to be a plan. 8, 9, sometimes 10 guys in the box for Wyoming defensively, but Donnell Pumphrey, an opportunity. Only 218 yards away from Ron Dayne as the all-time leader. An opportunity tonight in a big game.
Yeah, and Ron Dayne isn't happy about that, by the way, because they didn't include his bowl games. Meanwhile, as for the home team, Wyoming, they've got an outstanding running back themselves in Brian Hill. He's the fourth leading rusher in the nation. And Todd McShay, they've got a quarterback who can do everything except maybe keep those feet warm.
No one's going to keep their feet warm. I can't even talk. I'm so cold down here. But Josh Allen, I think, is probably the quarterback with the most talent in the country that nobody really knows about. Started watching tape on him this week and could not believe the skill set. Reminded me a lot of a young Joe Flacco. He's tall at 6'5". He's got good size at 222 pounds. And what I love is the ability to shed defenders and make plays on the move. He creates, he extends. Coaches don't always love this decision, but now they do. Look at that arm throwing out of bounds basically across his body in the middle of the field. Then while he's got to work on some of his touch throws, this is a classic cover two beater down the sideline. He just laser shows it in. This guy's fun to watch. I think he could have the biggest impact on this game depending on how he plays for Wyoming tonight.
It's the 37th meeting all time between these two rivals. It's the Mountain West Championship game. The kickoff is next.
The 2016 Mountain West Football Championship game. Brought to you by Dr. Pepper. It's a college football tradition. Aflac. In just one day, we process, approve, and pay. One day pay, only from Aflac. And Chick-fil-A. We didn't invent the chicken, just the chicken sandwich. This is Dr. Pepper Championship Week.
Expedia reminds you we are here at War Memorial Stadium in Laramie, Wyoming for tonight's 2016 Mountain West Football Championship game. And no place we'd rather be. And here we go, we're underway. Cooper Roth puts it in the air. Rashad Petty, who returned the opening kickoff for a score 2 weeks ago, will take a knee in the end zone. And we'll see the San Diego State offense first and their quarterback, Christian Chapman.
Yeah, Christian Chapman's been efficient this season. He needs to take some pressure off of Donnell Comfrey in this game with his play action pass. You can also take pressure off of back, Steve, by being 100% on your run checks, which means getting the ideal look for Pumphrey in the running game, not running towards blitzing situations or down safeties. And then he needs to make two or three or four plays with his feet on third downs to sustain drives.
Open up at the 25, and he opens under center. And he'll throw on first down. Chapman will take a shot down the field, and it's knocked away. Look for Micah Holder. Excellent coverage by Rico Gafford, but the Aztecs come out firing.
Yeah, great job by Gafford. This ball is perfectly thrown from Christian Chapman. Micah Holder is most reliable receiver. That's right where you want it. But Gafford just comes up with that right hand at the very end. Exactly how the defensive backs are taught. When that ball is in the hands, punch at it.
Reese, quick strategy question. San Diego State won the toss. Didn't want to put the top-ranked defense out there. They wanted the football to start. Is that a surprise?
Yeah, a little bit surprised. It is.
Second down and 10. Now they give it to Pumphrey. First carry. And he runs right up the middle. Stopped by Marcus Epps. As we take a look at tonight's impact players, brought to you by Chick-fil-A.
You know, maybe the only thing I can think about with Rocky Long is he wanted to get his two best players on the field, Donnell Pumphrey and Rashad Penny. Both of these running backs are outstanding. Lucas Walker, the most reliable linebacker. It's worth noting that Wyoming defensively tonight will be playing without their senior leader, DJ May, who was the best linebacker to match up with the speed of Donnell Pumphrey.
And don't be surprised to watch Pumphrey run inside the tackles. He is not a guy who just turns the corner. Nick Bawden is now the fullback to his left. They split out Pumphrey, and they throw out to the left to David Wells. Able to complete, he's short of the first down marker. And this has a championship game kind of feel, and there's the extracurricular, and a flag goes to the air. Marcus Epps had the coverage on David Wells. We'll check the marker. Referee is Kevin Marr tonight.
With the emotion of a rematch only 2 weeks later, Wyoming comes up with a big stop, and Antonio Hull gets a stop on the sideline, but is the penalty going to go against the Cowboys?
After the play was over, personal foul, unnecessary roughness, offense number 88, 15-yard penalty, fourth down.
That's David Wells, the tight end.
He caught the ball. I think he's going to catch some grief.
Well, he gets hit, and he didn't like the way he got hit on the outside. They came up to jab at him, jar at him, and he takes his helmet right at the... That's Marcus Epps. That's a good call by the official.
And that... You got to be encouraged if you're a Wyoming fan just because of the tackling. It's so important against Donnell Pumphrey and this entire San Diego State team. You've got to be able to tackle in the open field. That second and third down, great tackles to put San Diego State in this position.
That's a great point, Todd, because the two games that sandwiched this, the last game against San Diego State, Wyoming gave up 1,343 yards and 16 touchdowns to UNLV in New Mexico. They got to come out and get some confidence early.
So instead of fourth and one, it's fourth and 16, and Tanner Blaine will punt it away. And Austin Conway will call for the fair catch, but the Cowboys will start with excellent field position after the punt of just 38 yards. We talked about Josh Allen in the open. He's got high, high level of potential.
Well, it's kind of a surprise watching him on tape how physically gifted he is. I think he's, as Todd showed you, he walks the fine line between big plays and turnovers. 23 touchdowns, but 11 interceptions on the year. He's got to be better in that area. But, you know, I think he's one of the guys that people around college football haven't seen Josh Allen. You're going to see tonight a quarterback that can make every single throw, and that's faster than you think at that size.
Your eyes got big watching him in warm-ups, too. Those deep throws to the end zone. All ropes, especially tonight, frozen ropes. Hand off to Brian Hill. Back to the line of scrimmage. Stopped by Jay Henderson in the middle of that defensive unit for San Diego State.
Well, maybe the biggest, you know, compliment you can pay a quarterback is what how they perform in crunch time. And that's what jumped off the tape to me against Boise State and against San Diego State, two of the perennial powers in the Mountain West Conference. In the fourth quarter, Josh Allen played lights out, and that's why they won those two games.
They gave him a yard on that last carry, so we'll call it second and nine. Allen sends the man in motion and doesn't give it to anyone, and he is swallowed up by Ronley Lakalaka.
Yeah, he just took his eyes off the snap there. Sometimes you're in the backfield and you gotta fake to one guy, give it to the other, and just take your eye off the ball for a second and it goes through his hands. See him kind of, he's trying to fake it to one guy, and it's a little bit of concentration.
Nerves in a championship game at home.
It's cold out too now.
And the frozen football. Third and 14. Four wide receivers out. Hill's the single setback to the left of Allen. The throw. Feels a little pressure. Able to deliver. And it is caught. It's going to be short of the marker. Hits Tanner Gentry. That catch right in front of the Aztec sideline. There's a flag down back of the play.
Like a good catch, but I think this is coming back. The flag in the area of holding.
Holding. Offense number 74. 10-yard penalty. Repeat. Third down.
So each team with a bad penalty to start.
That's the right tackle, Brinkley Jolly. He's playing at the right tackle position in place of the injured Ryan Cummings, who went out in the Nevada game earlier in the year. Gonna have a big assignment here. He's trying to block Munson, the linebacker, and could have been called for a face mask as well.
Third down and 24. It's Brian Hill, the ball carrier. He picks up a couple. Brent Vegan, who's the offensive coordinator, said he recently had to deal with a fourth and 27, so that seemed much more manageable. But they're playing it safe, clearly.
Neither offense want to start the football game this way. You get a penalty if you're San Diego State. Wyoming gets a penalty just the same, and three and out.
Ethan Wood gets it away. It's Quest Truxton. And there's a flag down. Is Truxton making a few people miss? And he'll be tackled around midfield. Ethan Wood got to him. The punter had to make the tackle. We'll check the marker.
They're going to get a holding call on San Diego State. It's pretty blatant right at the reception point, which will negate a nice return. That's Kyrie Woods on the outside, number 27.
During the kick, holding receiving team number 27. Half the distance to the goal. First down, timeout.
Kevin Marr getting a little too much face time for my liking to start this Mountain West Conference Championship game. Second possession for San Diego State and Donnell Pumphrey. We come back. Life is good for Craig Bohl. turn around this season, 6 victories, get yourself a contract extension. He'll be here for the next 7 years, unless he won't be here, of course. There's a big buyout involved with that, but they just announced a new contract extension last night.
And yeah, and Rocky Long, just a model of consistency with the San Diego State program, back-to-back Mountain West Conference championship game.
Wow, here's Pumphrey, and he is rocked by Andrew Wingard.
Keep an eye out for Andrew Wingard in this game. He's the leading tackler in the Mountain West Conference. He's not afraid to fill the hole from his safety spot. Donnell Pumphrey has to account for him.
You know, this offensive line for San Diego State has about a 55-pound advantage across the board against Wyoming, so it's going to take consistency and tackling from the defensive backs, as we've seen so far early in this game.
San Diego State, that was part of their game plan, to impose their will at the line of scrimmage, especially in the fourth quarter. Here's Pumphrey again, spinning away, and will bring up a third down and short where Marcus Epps tripped him up.
You know, this Wyoming defense has been absolutely horrendous against the run in their last two games against UNLV and New Mexico. But that game against San Diego State 2 weeks ago, they only gave up 13 points. And they contained, held Donnell Pumphrey under 100 yards. So I think San Diego State needs to make the adjustments against this Wyoming defense. Get Donnell Pumphrey to the perimeter more rather than just running him between the tackles on power plays.
He is the single setback on 3rd and 3. Fake the jet and give it to Pumphrey. He stopped short. Stopped well short of the first down marker. Antonio Hall came up from the corner to make the tackle.
You got a corner in Antonio Hall that's about 6 or 7 yards deep on a running play, and there's no blocker for him. So if he's able to make that play on Donnell Pumphrey, you're not going to be able to convert that third down in short situation. It's going to have 10 guys in the box at times in this game.
So that's not an exaggeration.
10, no,
in, the, 10 in the box. Flags fly as Tanner Blaine tried to get it away.
False start. Kicking team, number 43. 5-yard penalty. Still fourth down.
I think Rocky Long understands that, yes, Donnell Pumphrey has struggled the last couple of games. I think it has been because they have played defenses that have really sold out against the run to stop the run, knowing that that's the biggest part of this offense. So when is Chapman going to be able to take that pressure off?
They back Blade up 5 more yards and out of his own end zone. He punched to Austin Conway. Picks up a block. Conway's across midfield. And Wyoming will start in San Diego State territory for their second possession in a scoreless championship game.
The 2016 Mountain West Football Championship game is presented by Hampton by Hilton. Book at Hampton.com for a guaranteed discount. And in part by Buick, proud partner of the NCAA.
Taco Bell is a proud partner of the College Football Playoff. Be on the lookout for Taco Bell student sections and passionate fans like these at games all season long and into the bowl season as well.
How do you like your first trip to Laramie there, Mr. Levy?
Pretty nice. Proud to say I have been to Wyoming twice before. That was Cody. My first trip to Cheyenne and Laramie, and hospitality's been off the charts.
You're used to this elevation, 7,200 feet. Just came from Mexico City, right? 9,000 feet?
Not a problem. Second possession for Wyoming. I always breathe this way. Allen fakes to Hill. Good pocket around him. Easy pitch and catch to Tanner Gentry. And he's forced out by Ron Smith.
Levy, that looks easy, but it's not. I mean, the way he can get behind his throws and drive the ball, it's effortless. I mean, this guy has a special arm, Brian.
Yeah, I was really jealous watching him on Thursday night. You know, the cold doesn't affect him. What you'll notice is his hand is so large, doesn't have any issue with the grip on the ball. Even though it's cold and dry, the ball can get slippery. And then he's got long levered, so he just effortless throwing the football.
6 minutes in, we have our first down. And that'll go as an incomplete pass. Four penalties, three punts, and one first down as Gentry took a beating there from Demonte Casey.
Yeah, this would have been a completion to Gentry if it weren't for Casey coming up and putting a helmet on the football.
That's what Casey does so well. He plays a lot of zone coverage, reads the quarterback's eyes, gets an early jump, and he is physical for his size at that cornerback position.
He is the two-time consecutive Mountain West Defensive Player of the Year. We'll watch for him all night. Second down and 10 after the incomplete pass. Play fake to Hill. Down. Wanted to show off that speed. He'll only get one, but you could see the quick acceleration out of the pocket and out of the trouble and into Alex Barrett's hands.
I really felt the difference in the game that they played 2 weeks ago, with San Diego State was not ready for the athletic ability of Josh Allen. He's so quick, even though he's 6'5", 230 pounds, he can run faster than any of the linebackers for San Diego State. So the adjustment for Rocky Long to keep him in the pocket, constrict that pocket, great job there on a second and long.
Calvin Munson admitted it. They got caught off guard. They did not expect him to be as fast as he was. Here's third and eight. Pressure from the outside. He was hit as he throws. Jay Henderson rushed Allen into that throw to bring up a fourth down.
That's Jay Henderson, their junior linebacker, who they love to play on the outside. Rocky Long is a pressure defensive coordinator. He's going to bring three linebackers, and Jay Henderson is the one that's unblocked and a young quarterback. Josh Allen's talented, but he's still inexperienced in his first year as a full-time starter. Never saw him coming.
Here's Cooper Roth on for a 46-yard attempt. Kick is on the way. Off the crossbar and through. Had just enough.
There's never a doubt on that one.
Never, really? Like they were Cooper had to say. He ties his career high with a 46-yard field goal. 46 yards and an inch. And good enough for our first points. Wyoming in the Mountain West championship game, 3-0. Celebrating its 12th year sponsoring the Good Hands Field Goal Nets, Allstate makes contributions to participating universities' general scholarship funds for each field goal and extra point kick. To date, Allstate has contributed millions in scholarship funds. Last time these two schools got together, just a couple of weeks ago, regular season, Josh Allen hooks up with C.J. Johnson for a score. That gave Wyoming a 34-27 lead with 67 seconds left. But the Aztecs weren't done. Watch this play. Quest Truxton barely hangs on to that tip pass to make it 34-33. And then instead of the extra point, San Diego State goes for two. The pass batted away by Antonio Hull. And that's how the Cowboys won 34-33. How about that decision?
So the biggest question all week for Rocky Long has been, are you going to go for two in that situation again? Do you have more plays dialed up? Rocky Long held it. Said, no, we got the same amount of plays.
He's going for the win. I like it. Jawan Washington gets his first carry of the game. Lucas Walker makes the stop.
Three backs we'll see for San Diego State. Jawan Washington and Rashard Perry, who both had kickoff return touchdowns in this game 2 weeks ago. And then obviously Donnell Pumphrey. But so far, two kickoffs for Wyoming. Both of them have been touchbacks. That was a big area of concern for head coach Craig Bohl. So far, so good.
Penny is in there now. They sent him in motion top of your screen in the slot. Chapman a throw. Chapman able to connect for first down yardage.
Chapman's pass complete.
It's Quest Truxton in the traffic. Gain of 8 on the play.
And I like that response by Christian Chapman. Second down. Get a first down. Throw on the football. He's only going to throw about 15, 16 times in this game. So it's hard to really get a rhythm as a quarterback when you're not throwing it as much. But that's the recipe that San Diego State has had for the last couple of years. But when he has those opportunities and guys open on first and second down pass, he's got to convert.
Aztecs get their first down of the game. Penny and Pumphrey are both in there, and it's Rashad Penny in all sorts of trouble. He's going to be dropped for a loss in a big way. Kevin Prosser got him in the backfield.
Kevin Prosser on the outside. Both these guys, they're not going to be fooled. They understand that Pumphrey sometimes is just eye candy. Rashard Penny is a very versatile back as well. They were not fooled, Todd.
They had some trouble, though, with the misdirection a couple weeks ago, and that was a point of emphasis. They told us in the meetings when we asked about it, they've got to be smart with their eyes, disciplined with their eyes, and do their job.
Prosser the tackle, solid tackle for the loss of 7. Second and 17. Chapman under pressure, throw back, appears his body, it's tipped in the air and intercepted. Intercepted by Sidney Malauulu.
There was question whether Malauulu would even play in this game with a foot injury. Didn't practice much at all this week. Recognizes a screen. Look at that athletic ability. He's their biggest defensive lineman, 6'3", 301 pounds from Seoul, South Korea, and he makes the biggest play of the game so far.
Looked like a center getting an entry pass. I mean, tipped it up to himself. Soft hands for the big guy.
Walker and Prosser had the pressure. That leads to our first turnover of the game. And the Cowboys look to be in business at the San Diego State 17. Hand off to Brian Hill. Just across the line of scrimmage, Jay Henderson, his second tackle of this young game.
And that's such a big play for Malauulu, because the thinnest part of this Wyoming team is the defensive line. They're playing without two of their starters. Chase Appleby, a senior who was a captain, not playing in this game because of a knee injury. And Carl Granderson, so they're very thin on that defensive line. But Malauulu makes a huge play.
Second down and 9. Give it to Hill, able to squeeze through for a few. Still brings up a third and long. And if you're the Cowboys, you don't want to settle for a field goal here after that turnover.
No, in this situation, third and medium, it's where they love to spread defenses out. Craig Bohl realizes that Rocky Long's going to probably bring pressure. They love to go empty sets. And in those cases, they want to find Tanner Gentry, number 4. He'll line up in the slot almost exclusively. You see a wide set here. Here's Gentry, and sometimes they love to bring the back out of the backfield and isolate him on a safety or linebacker.
Aztecs show pressure, and they bring it. Allen throw into the end zone, caught, touchdown. Jacob Hollister goes up for it. Who said anything about settling for a field goal? That's 6 for the Cowboys.
Huge turnover by Malauulu, and a great play. And Jacob Hollister, probably the most versatile tight end Wyoming has on this offense, goes up for the jump ball and gets the first touchdown of the game.
Roth puts it through. So Wyoming very much at home in this conference championship game. They get the interception, and that leads to the touchdown pass. Jacob Hollister from Josh Allen. 10-0 Cowboys.
Welcome back to Laramie. 10-0 game, Wyoming Cowboys. Great conversion by that offense. Punching the ball in after the turnover by Malauulu. Take a 2-score lead in this football game.
And they do it quick. 3 plays, 17 yards. Minute 26 coming off the clock. See if Rashad Penny gets a chance. And Penny at the goal line. He will look to return it for the first time. He can make people miss. Here's Penny. And he is dragged out of the 38 by Jalen Ortiz. Set for an update. Here's Adnan Virk. Adnan will keep you posted on everything going on around college football on this championship Saturday night. That regular season fly by or what?
Man, it seems like just yesterday we were at Lambeau doing Wisconsin LSU. Todd jumping up doing the Lambeau leap.
We didn't think Wisconsin was going to be very good, did we? Wow, what a season the Badgers have had. Let's see what happens tonight. On first down, off the play fake. Chapman ready to throw again and nearly intercepted again. Marcus Epps with his hands to his head. Thought he should have picked that one clean.
Yeah, great read by Epps. Felt like this Wyoming defense and their defensive coordinator, Steve Stannard, felt like if they take away the inside run and then the boots, those are the two biggest things San Diego State likes to do offensively. And Epps, that time, was all over the boot pass.
Second down and 10. Handoff, here's Pumphrey. He's out across the 40-yard line.
Really enjoyed talking to Donnell Pumphrey last night. He's such a energetic. He's got an effervescence about him. He's only 170 pounds, maybe. They list him at 180, but he's more like 175.9. But the thing I impressed most about him is the durability. You don't have 5,000 yards rushing and another 1,000 receiving if you're not durable, tough, and there for your team when they need you.
Over 300 touches each of the last three seasons, including this one. Penny and Pumphrey are both out there. That's Truxton in motion, top of your screen. Here's Chapman to throw. Checks it down to Penny. And see if he has it up for the first down.
Last complete to Penny. Brought down by 42.
Looks like they're going to mark him. First down.
They're going to give it to him.
It's a big first down there. Down 10-0 first quarter. The danger of this game going in the wrong direction. San Diego State's lost their last two games. And they have done it in very depressing fashion. They have got to get some good mojo going here in the first half.
Lost 63-31 last week to Colorado State. Fresh set of downs. Off the play fake. Chapman rolling and running. And he's bounced out. It's a 3 yards short of that first down. San Diego State, 9-3 in the season, 6-2 in conference play. Well, they started 9-1. Their best win was against Cal. They lost the last couple in a big way to Wyoming and Colorado State, and now making their second straight Mountain West championship appearance. Tells you how good they were, right? That you could lose your last two games and still play in the conference championship game.
And really the strength of their team has been their defense. They've been the best defense in the Mountain West Conference under Rocky Long, who serves as their defensive coordinator as well as their head coach.
They were running out of time there after burn a timeout. Play clock was down to 2.
But the last 2 weeks have kind of gotten away from them. You know, you talked to Coach Long, and certainly that game here 2 weeks ago, you lose on a failed two-point conversion. It took a lot of the emotion out of his team, and he felt like they got steamrolled by CSU, as you mentioned last week. It was a buzzsaw. CSU's playing really good football on the offensive side, but for them to give up 63 points, that was a humbling experience for Coach Long.
Did you like that going for 2 in that spot?
Yeah, you know. Listen, Rocky Long's been doing this a long time. He's the winningest coach at Mountain West Conference. And, you know, he's won a lot of games by having an aggressive nature. Defenses are aggressive, and I love the fact that he translated that over to the offensive side.
One thing that's big to watch in this game is turnovers. This San Diego State defense, I know they're on offense now, but the defense is number 3 in the FBS since the start of 2015 in takeaways. Only had 1 in the last meeting against Wyoming.
All right, they come out of the timeout on 2nd down and 5 and hand off to Rashad Penny. Penny's got the first down and plenty more. Penny with a stiff arm, and he's finally brought down at about the 16-yard line of Wyoming.
Everybody wants to talk about Donnell Pumphrey, and nobody's talking about Rashad Penny. Watch him make both safeties miss in the hole. That's Wingard, the leading tackler in the Mountain West Conference, and another safety, and he just makes both of them miss and then a stiff arm on the back end.
Gain of 29 on the play. We asked Penny about looking forward to next season, right? Pumphrey's not going to be around. All those carries and that role will fall to Penny, and he's certainly excited about that. Second man through. Here's Pumphrey. And he bangs down
Pumphrey inside the 10-yard line.
Inside the 10, Marcus Epps brought him down, very close to a first down.
You know, we talk a lot about these backs, but we got to give some credit to their fullback that's been leading in front of them, Nick Bowden. He's got the long hair, tough guy, converted from a quarterback, which I can tell you from experience, most quarterbacks do not end up as fullbacks. Maybe a tight end or two, but
safety,
not a fullback. This guy is a beast.
Second down and short. Bowden's in there. And they hand it to Pumphrey. He's got the first down, and he's got the touchdown. Donnell Pumphrey, end zone. Aztecs on the board.
I mean, there's a joystick element to this young guy. I mean, in the hole, he never panics. Even though there's free guys in the hole, he's used to it because he's used to 8-9-man boxes. That time he had the safety wingered again and a corner, and he just makes the, you know, hits the B button spin move and is into the end zone.
The yards after contact, so impressive. There's John Barron on for the extra point. He's got 100 points on the season. John Barron does. Make it 101. 9-yard run for Pumphrey. 3 minutes off the scoring drive.
Take a look. Three guys in the hole. There's two of them. One, two. And if you don't wrap up and secure Donnell Pumphrey, he will make you look terrible, Todd.
Wrap up? How do you even have a chance sometimes? I've watched plenty of tape of this guy. This is the first time I've been standing 20 yards away and actually get to see him live. The defender had no shot at all. I mean, his ability to change direction and then accelerate off the cut is special. That's why he's got a chance to be a third, fourth round draft pick and play in the league for a long time, a lot like a Darren Sproles.
We talked to Pumphrey yesterday. You know, he's trying to be humble and talking about his team's defense. They need to be successful and the entire team. And then I said, okay, what about this? And we slapped the Pumphrey for a Heisman list in front of him. And I said, what jumps out to you? And he looked at some of those names. And I just passed Tony Dorsett. Hey, I appreciate that the young kids recognize and know all about the big-time former players.
Yeah, you definitely put him on the spot. You know, you see how much history he knew of Tony Dorsett.
He aced your test.
Yeah, he put it right back in your face.
Nick Shea, he aced yours. You asked him how many yards he needs for number one all time, and he had that 218
on
the tip of his tongue. So as he inches closer to the all-time record, rushing in a career 10-7 game, big special teams lick. Nico Evans is dropped at the 15. I mentioned Dorsett. I mean, that's just one name. As the yards pile up,
it's crazy. He went from 75th most at the beginning of the year to now third, jumping all of these guys. I mean, this is amazing. It's awe-inspiring to see these names and how Donnell Pumphrey has passed them this season. He said LaDainian Tomlinson has been his favorite running back since the very beginning of him starting to play football.
I mean, it was a quick glance. Those names flew by, and they got to all be College Football Hall of Famers.
Yeah.
And many of them in the Pro Football Hall of Fame as well. Here's Allen to throw. Intercepted! Allen down the sideline was picked off. It's Casey! DeMonte Casey is stopped just short of the goal line.
Casey was trying to get that ball in the end zone. He fumbled the football. They're talking this over whether this could be a touchback. He's diving for the end zone.
That's Allen who banged him out.
That ball comes out. First question is, was his right foot out of bounds? He's inbounds, so that's definitely a fumble. Now the question is, where does the ball go?
Ruling on the field was that the runner fumbled prior to crossing the goal line. Fumbled out of the end zone for a touchback.
This play, Steve, is great effort on both sides. KZ's trying to make a play, trying to punch the ball into the end zone. We see players every week dive for that pylon, their coach to do that. But give credit to Josh Allen. He makes a huge mistake throwing the football and getting intercepted, but he doesn't give up on the play. If he doesn't get over there with effort, this is a touchdown.
Yeah, we learned a lot about him right there. Some guys might have had their head down or not gotten over in position, tried to protect themselves, but he just made a beeline for it and laid out and gave everything he had to try to make up for his mistake.
You can see he knew it was a late throw right off the bat.
And then look at that. He goes to the touchback signal. Allen's got it all.
Well, we were talking to Craig Bohl last night about his young quarterback. And he says, yes, he's got all the skills, the tools. He can run. He can throw. But maybe his most impressive trait is his competitiveness. And you saw it right there. Didn't give up on the play. Knows he made a mistake. Tried to atone for it.
We'll wait for the official review, but that certainly looks like the call on the field will stand. Greasy, you've been in that spot. You've thrown at least one interception.
That's real funny.
College or pro, I'm saying, but what's that like to not get annoyed at yourself and take it out on the guy who just picked you off?
Well, it takes a tremendous amount of focus. You know, if that were me, I'm not fast enough to get over there. He would have walked into the end zone if that was me. But you know what? This kid can run, and he knows he can run. And he gives the effort to get over there. There's no hesitation. He knows exactly where the pylon is. It's impressive. This kid was named a captain. He was named a captain of the team, having not played a whole lot. He only played one game a year ago. Tells you what his teammates think of him.
From a small town, Firebrow, California, a town we're told that has two stoplights in it.
He's laughing it off.
If this stands, Wyoming actually will gain 9 yards on the interception.
Now, all that being said, I think it's worth noting that it seems as though San Diego State is not concerned with Wyoming throwing the ball down the field. They're sitting on routes. KZ sat all over that route. So that's something that if I'm offensive coordinator Brent Vegan for Wyoming, I might come back and take a shot here.
Yeah, and typically the big arm quarterbacks are the ones that think that they can fit the ball in. And it's a good opportunity for this opportunistic defense. I mentioned the takeaways from San Diego State have been
After
so important
review,
the last couple of years.
The ruling on the field is confirmed. It is a touchback. First down, Wyoming.
Judson Howard is our replay judge tonight. And it's effort on both parts. KZ gives it. He's trying to reach out for the end zone.
Yep.
He's trying to score a touchdown. Makes a great play on the interception.
First and 10 for the Bucs.
Still can't get over Josh Allen.
Well, that's been the MO for San Diego State defensively. That's their 21st interception on the season. And you see how many KZ has.
San Diego State was just inches from having 14 points in 16 seconds. That's Brian Hill, the ball carrier. We've got another update from Adnan Virk. Adnan, thank you. Second down and 8. Hand off to Brian Hill. He'll gain a few on the play. Speaking of Wisconsin, you mentioned the 21st interception greased by San Diego State. They tie the Badgers. That's the most in FBS.
I think a lot of that has to do with the aggressive style of Rocky Long. His 3-3-5 patented defense. We've got 3 defensive linemen, 3 linebackers, and then 5 secondary players. Talking with him last night, he felt like he needed to change up a little bit. Didn't want to do too much, but he needed to change up to really slow down this Wyoming attack, which is the best offensive attack from a point standpoint in the Mountain West Conference.
Flags go. See who jumped with 14 seconds left in this first quarter.
False start. Offense number 55. 5-yard penalty. Still third down.
That's the true freshman, Gavin Rush.
Yeah, Rush has been played solid for a true freshman. Anytime you're thrown in there, it's difficult to adjust, but certainly he's the guy they like to pull. If they run power plays to the right, they'll pull the left guard Rush because he's got a little bit more ability than their right guard, Cade Jackson.
You cold?
I'm good.
McShay, are you cold? Todd, it's cold down there?
Don't worry about it.
You know, you have all our sympathy. 10-7, Cowboys after one in the Mountain West Championship game. Who's really in? No, I mean, like, actually, who's really, really in? Greece, you know who's in?
check tomorrow.
Who's in? Find out tomorrow at noon. ESPN's four-hour special, the exclusive reveal, the college football playoff semifinal in the Chick-fil-A Peach Bowl and the PlayStation Fiesta Bowl on December 31st. Reese and the fellas will have all the bowl matchups for you. High anticipation of that program around most of the country. That should be something special. We all think we know, but we don't really know until noon tomorrow.
False start. Offense number 72. 5-yard penalty. Third down.
I mean, the only wild card remaining is the Clemson game, in my opinion. So if Clemson were to lose, then certainly there's some more access created for whether it's the Big Ten champ or for Michigan. But I think if Clemson holds serve, pretty much know who's going to be in.
So we feel good about Row the Boat going to Dallas, huh? Cotton Bowl?
These two teams had designs on that Cotton Bowl, that Group of Five bid, until the last 3 weeks of the season happened.
Good job, P.J. Fleck and company. Dumped out of Brian Hill. Stiff arm there, and you hear the collision. But he's got first down yardage. Austin Wyatt Thayer. Able to stop. I beg you, just short, I said. I beg your pardon, of that first down. And that makes the stop by Wyatt Thayer that much better. Was third and 13, brings up a fourth and six.
Quest Truxton will go deep and receive the kick. Ethan Wood is on the punt for Wyoming.
Quest Truxton is back, standing at his own 33. Ethan Wood will blast it away. Truxton has to take a few steps back. Tripped up. Excellent coverage by Wyoming. And Logan Wilson. Adnan Burke, what say you? Fair enough.
Wow, that was the one I really had a question about. Could Virginia Tech and that defense under Bud Foster contain that Clemson offense enough? Because you know Jerrod Evans had that offense rolling. But certainly Clemson up two touchdowns already.
10-7 here, Wyoming. San Diego State was the ball. Pumphrey the carrier. Wilson the tackle. The numbers on Pumphrey for the last couple of weeks, we documented, had just 53 yards rushing a week ago, 76 yards rushing 2 weeks ago right here. Came in needing to average 109 yards in these last two games to pass the great Rondane. Second and 7. That's Truxton in the slot. Chapman gonna take off. No slide there as he's drilled down by Josiah Hall.
It's a great quick decision from Christian Chapman. Tried to throw a quick game, a little out route to the left side of the field, and he was going to throw it into a zone defender. Would have been intercepted. Didn't panic. Got 5-6 yards, brought up a third manageable situation where they're still able to run the football.
Third down and 2. Crowd gets loud. They made it free for the students here to attend this game here tonight at Wyoming. Gonna throw for it. Chapman down the middle of the field, took a shot, and it's Micah Holder. And he has the first down and much more. How about that on third and 2?
Yeah, great job by Chapman. You're gonna see, he's just gonna sneak out Holder there. Here he comes, he's just gonna go up the field. Great play action, but look at the placement on this throw, Leaves. Perfectly put for Micah Holder where the defender Epps can't get to it.
Gain of 30 on the play, and they do use Pumphrey as a decoy.
Absolutely, absolutely.
Freezes everybody.
And you know, if they're going to win this game, well, their offensive coordinator Jeff Horton has got to have some plays like that. Got to take 4 or 5 shots down the field.
Play fake again to Pumphrey. Chapman hit as he throws, and it was short. looking for Truxton. Todd.
And with Chapman, height is an issue. He's behind a massive offensive line and struggles at times to see. But you saw on the deep thrower, he connected. He had protection. He was deep enough in his drop. And then also they're going to try to get him outside the pocket where it's easier for him to see the entire field.
That's a great point, Todd. They did that in last year's Mountain West Championship game. People forget Chapman started that football game and ended up being the offensive MVP of that football game when they beat Air Force.
9-14, 203 yards and a score. That was his first win as a starting quarterback on second down and 10. Penny turns the corner. Very close to the first down marker. Antonio Hall pushed him out.
Just to finish with Jeff Horton, he told us yesterday he really believes as this offense continues to go in this game, the physical nature of their offensive line, and as Todd mentioned, how much they outweigh that Wyoming defensive line, the 2-yard gain in the first quarter turns into a 4-yard gain in the second quarter, a 6-yard in the third, and then an 8-yard gain or maybe a touchdown in the fourth quarter as they start to wear them down.
Third and three. Baldwin, the fullback's in there. Penny's the ball carrier, has the first down. Dropped at exactly the 20-yard line by Shiloh Windsor.
Well, you do everything you possibly can, Wyoming defensively, to get Shiloh Windsor free in the backfield. Number 92, there he is. And I'm sorry, your athlete at San Diego State's better than their athlete at Wyoming in that case. And Penny takes a 2-yard loss and turns it into a first down.
First down and 10. Humphrey. And that's one way of keeping people fresh is that they have Penny and Pumphrey who both run the football.
Yeah, so far you can see how Pumphrey has started to take over. Watch this block by Bowden just blowing up the defensive linebacker back-to-back times. This time you get a free secondary, that's Winger, two free secondary players, and then the corner and the patented spin move from Donnell Pumphrey, who said to us yesterday, this is the most important game of his career. Saying a lot, 52 games he's played in his career at San Diego State.
Chapman under some pressure trying to get out of there. And he'll be chased and slammed out of bounds. Prosser knocked him out along with Walker.
Yeah, it was good coverage there. They tried to get the ball to Donnell Pumphrey on a little out route. Pumphrey is the leading receiver on the team also, which is a little surprising when you look at it, 26 catches coming into this game.
Not in receiving yards, but yes, in receptions. He is the do-it-all, do-everything.
Be interesting to see if this is four-down territory for Rocky Long and if he communicates to Christian Chapman as such, knowing he doesn't need to force the ball down the field.
Ninth play of the drive upcoming. Just get it away. Humphrey stopped. Rocked by Malalulu, who had the interception earlier. Malalulu comes up with the run stop there on fourth down, leaving it fourth down.
What is Rocky Long going to do here? Fourth and 9. I think he's going to kick, which if they would have been in a fourth and 4-3, maybe he would have gone for it. But
I think that was the design, was to try to get a fourth and 3 with that play call.
37-yard attempt from John Barron out of the hold of Tanner Blaine. And just squeezes it through. John Barron does. Wyoming scored the first 10. And they're able to hold there, only giving up the field goal. We're all tied up in the Mountain West Championship game. Whether you're talking about tonight's game, the NCAA FCS Championship game, bowl games, college football playoff semifinals, national championship game, you know what? Stream every game live on the ESPN app and on Watch ESPN. Take us with you.
How many Carhartts do you think they're in the stands today? Do you know what a Carhartt is, Mr. Long Island?
Mr. More of an explanation there. Is that to keep your engine block warm?
Oh, jeez. I can't believe that. You got it.
All right, well, tell the people.
Cold weather gear, man.
Oh, Carhartt.
The working folks, yeah.
Right, boots.
Boots, overalls.
So why do you know about it, then?
I mean, you wore a bolo today. I give you credit for that, but yeah. I could have made you put the Carhartts on.
The South Florida kid. Touchback. Adnan, what are you wearing right now, Adnan, to keep warm in the studio? Thank you. Play that one inside. Not much doing there. This is tied for the second coldest game in terms of temperature in San Diego State history. And they recorded history a couple of years ago at Boise. They played a 9-degree game. Yeah, they lost that game 38-29.
So far, they've responded. You know, you think these kids from Southern California are going to come up and just lay down, but San Diego State, especially defensively, leaves coming off 63 points against Colorado State last week. So far, they've held the number one offense in the Mountain West Conference to 50 yards through a quarter and a half.
Second down and 9. Now looking to take off, runs right up the middle, has plenty of running room, but he's finally tackled down from behind by Malik Smith, but he's got first down yardage.
Yeah, this is what Rocky Long wanted to avoid, were these big gaping lanes for Josh Allen to run. You see the speed and the acceleration, and it's just because it's a safety that catches him from behind that he goes down, Todd.
Check on Todd's microphone in a second.
I think San Diego State defensively needs to continue to blitz and bring secondary players to get Josh Allen on the ground because they're fast enough to catch him, Steve.
There's Sean Wick, the ball carrier. Leans forward for 3. Sergio Phillips in the middle of that defense for San Diego State.
And when we were talking with Rocky Long yesterday, he said, you know, we're not the kind of team to just push the pocket and contain and very vanilla. I want to come after people. And so he'll bring corner blitzes. He'll bring safeties off the edge. Guys that are able not only to get Josh Allen on the ground, but to catch him in the first place.
Second and 7 upcoming. I'm a little worried about McShay, gotta be honest. Wick stays in there.
As long as his lips aren't frozen, we'll be all right.
Play fake. Allen in some trouble. Throwing it down the sideline and throwing that one away.
I think my audio pack froze. I couldn't hear you guys. It's actually kind of pleasant for 2 or 3 plays. I didn't even notice.
Cheap shot.
You know, we got McShay on a horse, and now he's all mad because he turns out to be allergic to a horse. How are we supposed to know that?
How is that our fault?
Hey, live and learn, right?
You didn't look so hot yesterday, partner.
No, it was not a good look. You guys had to put me to bed.
There's Todd. 40 years after the release of Rocky, there's Todd McShay. Wyoming has just 62 yards of total offense right now. They're going to get some help there. Kyle Kelly offside.
False start. Offense, number 74. 5-yard penalty. Still third down.
Not Kelly.
They're going to get Brinkley Jolly. Yeah, the right tackle. Yeah, he got a little flinch. Good catch by the official. This team, Wyoming, especially Josh Allen, they, more than any other team I've seen this year, Steve, love to use the hard count, especially in third down situations. They were going to get a free play there, but Jolly just flinched.
Third and 13 after the marker. Now they're going to take off. He runs into some big people, like Kyle Kelly that time. And he'll bring up a fourth down.
Boy, another stop for San Diego State defensively. And that's exactly what they wanted Josh Allen to do. They give him a little bit of lane, knowing that they got third and 13. They've got plenty of time to rally to get him on the ground and force the punt.
Last 3 possessions for Wyoming. The interception and 2 3 and outs.
Yep.
Truxton will let it bounce, and it will settle at the 12. Check in on the local rodeo team when we come back. All even at 10 in the Mountain West Championship game.
The 2016 Mountain West Football Championship game, brought to you by AT&T and Taco Bell's new Steakhouse Burrito and Steakhouse Nachos. No reservations, no garnishes, just the steakhouse good stuff.
Go Cowboys!
That's the University of Wyoming rodeo team, and there they are enjoying the football game tonight. Cowboys have had a rodeo team since 1949. They've won 12 national championships. The team will compete at 10 college rodeos throughout the school year with hope of qualifying for the College National Finals Rodeo in Casper, Wyoming in June. And I think I know which rodeo team we're rooting for. Yeah,
absolutely. The Cowgirls are currently in second place, Steve, after the fall season. Gillette College is in first. We've got work to do.
We're not rooting tonight, but we're rooting for rodeo. Go Pokes, indeed. And they were kind enough to lend an assisting hand to us.
Look at McShay. I mean, yeah, you had to make
that. That was great technique.
You look way too comfortable up there, Grease.
That was Grace.
Get over.
Grace was awesome. I gotta give credit. That's Peyton. Right? Peyton got you on the first try. And, you know, she got you a little bit around the teeth, but what were the odds her name being Peyton?
Right, Peyton's perfect. And I was under the impression this was to lasso you around your feet. That's how they usually lasso. And instead, they lasso around my giant melon. On second down and eight, Rashad Penny, the ball carrier.
Well, in all seriousness, we need to say thank you to the head rodeo coach, George Howard. He was awesome. You know, you had a horse, McShay had a horse, and thankfully didn't have to run the barrels or anything, but we had a great time with the team.
Great experience, you know, and when in Rome or when in Wyoming, and you want to be part of the experience, Mountain West Championship game, Cowboys the home team. You fit in so well here. I know you haven't shaved in a month.
I live out here, you know that, right?
Yeah. You're a mountain man. Third down and eight. Forget about it. Nothing doing. This Wyoming defense want to get off the field. Johanna Gaffon, the big stop there.
Well, this defensive line for Wyoming was put on notice. We mentioned they're the thinnest unit on the team for Wyoming. Everybody wants to talk about their offense, and this defense has been run through the last 3 weeks of the season. But we've had two big plays, one there by Johanna Gaffon, and then Sidney Malauulu with the interception led to the first touchdown.
Here's Blaine to punt it away to Austin Conway. Wow, what a punt this is! And it takes a San Diego State bounce as well. All the way down to the 15-yard line. That's a 75-yard punt. Good on you, Tanner Blaine. Adnan, thank you. 1974 was the last time that San Diego State won consecutive conference titles, span of some 42 years. They find themselves all even with Wyoming here at 10, under 5 to play in the first half. Allen will keep it himself. I haven't seen him slide yet, have you? He takes on some big hits. That was KZ who got him. Maybe a little payback for the hit Allen had on KZ on the interception return.
He's going to run the ball 15, 16 times in each game. And he got hit right in the chops from Casey there. He's tall, 6'5". It's not easy to get low when you're 6'5". It's a big target to hit.
Second down and eight. He's carried it 5 times so far for 17 yards tonight. Here's Allen throwing on the run and completing. Jordan Ellis out of the backfield, the fullback, his first catch of the night.
Even the speed there by Allen to be able to get around the defender. I was standing right behind him in the end zone and didn't have a clear window to throw the ball, but knew he was fast enough to get around in time to put that ball on the money.
And that was the report we got on Josh Allen. He does the really difficult stuff really well.
Yep.
That's his strength, the hard stuff. You see the numbers on Allen. Got 10 on that last play. Tight ends, That's Conway in motion, the jet action, and handoff to Brian Hill. Sergio Phillips will stop.
What a season it's been for Wyoming Cowboys and Craig Bohl. 2-10 last season, and everybody, I'm talking everybody, picked them last at the beginning of this year in the Mountain West, and all they do is run off 6-2 in the conference. Their first conference championship since 1996. And Craig Bohl, what else can you say? 36th year coaching. He's been a part of 5 national championships, 3-time national champion, a consecutive national champion at North Dakota State.
And that's where he had Carson Wentz. Josh Allen told us he hears about the comparison probably once a day. Someone mentions the Carson Wentz comparison to Josh Allen. And he gets to work with the same head coach, recruited by the same guy.
Yep, just signed a 5-year extension through 2023. Did Coach Bohl, going to make about $1.5 million, which is getting him more up to speed with the top coaches. Brian Harsin, Boise State in the Mountain West Conference, and he deserves every bit of it. I think he's the perfect fit here in Laramie for the Cowboys.
3rd and 5. Now it'll pitch. That'll go as an incomplete forward pass, trying to get it to Brian Hill.
We've been talking about these the horses and you guys being on the horses. Coach Bohl bought a horse when he first got the job with the Wyoming Cowboys. He said, you know, I want to fit into the culture. So he and his wife bought a horse. He said he went, he was riding the horse. The horse bucked him off. He fell off, hurt his ribs, stood up and looked the horse in the eye and said, well, I guess I got to get back on this thing or else he will win. And he did so.
Quest trucked him. Nearly got trucked there. There is a flag down. He's able to spin ahead for a couple of extra yards.
Truxton on the return out to the 35-yard line after a 41-yard kick.
It's a 42-yard punt, so it's not a 75-yard punt like we saw. It flipped some of the field position. Check the penalty.
During the return, block in the back, receiving team number 4. 10-yard penalty, first down, timeout.
Minute 44 to play in this first half. The Mountain West Championship game, all time. Gonna ask you to help us beat cancer. Log on to www.jimmyv.org or call 1-800-4-JIMMY-V to donate. All donations benefit the V Foundation for Cancer Research. That's not gonna be the last time we ask you to help us beat cancer. Get involved, people. Minute 44 left here in the first half, all even, 10. Mountain West Championship game. San Diego State on 1st and 10 from the 20. Here's Donnell Pumphrey, has some running room. Pumphrey spinning away from one tackler, and this is his biggest gain of the night. He's out across to the 43-yard line.
And I think they just need to get Donnell Pumphrey on the edge more, and this is just him with vision cutting back. There's no blockers out there, but him one-on-one on the perimeter in space is a no-brainer. Antonio Hull has no chance.
That's a 23-yard gain. Pumphrey up now to 57 yards on 11 carries. Had just 34 prior to that big run. Here's Chapman to throw. Under some pressure, and he's throwing that one away to Michael Holder over his head and out of bounds. Adnan. See what you did there. 2nd down and 10 now. Here's Chapman throwing across the middle, couldn't hook up with Holder. Bring up a 3rd down and 10. Keep in mind, San Diego State is down a timeout. They had to use one after Chapman ran in the second quarter, had his wristband ripped off, and they had some confusion getting the play call.
Yeah, but if San Diego State doesn't get a first down here, Wyoming will be the one using one of their 3 remaining timeouts to try to save some time for Josh Allen and their offense.
Chapman's very good on 3rd down. 3 of 3. trying to convert. Here's third and 10, the big one, big spot. Flag goes down, able to hook up with Holder. They're going to say he did catch it. He was in bounds. We'll see if it comes back for holding. Still the presence of Christian Chapman. Very impressive.
Great job by Chapman.
Holding. Offense number 75. 10-yard penalty. We'll replay third down.
Not easy to hold when you have a broken hand either.
Yeah, that's Quade Miller. Playing left tackle. He's got a speed rusher on the outside, Prosser, and he just gets that arm around there and negates a wonderful effort there by Chapman, which would have had a first down in Cowboy territory with still the remaining two timeouts.
See that cast or that club that's on Miller's right hand.
Yeah, it's tough. It's tough to play offensive line without being able to engage with that with both hands.
Third and 20. Chapman crossed the line of scrimmage and then out of bounds. Gain of three, maybe.
Yeah, thinking back right there, you know, you want to stay in bounds. You want to force them at least to use one of their timeouts, but Chapman just goes right out of bounds, and Wyoming keeps all three timeouts. Those are the X's and O's, and the 101, football 101 and playing quarterback is going down in bounds.
Needed 20, got five. They need another 75-yard punt here by Tanner Blaine. Austin Conway will let it bounce. And it will settle nicely at the 22 with 55 seconds left in this first half. Tomorrow here on ESPN, get your NFL started the right way, and it's starting earlier. We're going to start at 9 a.m. Eastern tomorrow, NFL Insider Sunday edition. Then at 10 a.m. this week, Chris Berman of the Best in the Business Sunday NFL Countdown. And then on ESPN's Monday Night Football, it's the Jets and the Colts. Got the official word today. Andrew Luck will start for Indianapolis. 8:15 Eastern. Coverage begins Monday Night Countdown, served by Applebee's at 6. We'll see you from East Rutherford on Monday night.
It's a big drive for Wyoming here. It's been up and down for them in this first half. Can they get anything going before halftime?
With all three timeouts, Allen throwing across the middle and completing for the huge chunk to Jake Mulhart. His first catch for the California native.
And before this drive, Josh Allen has only been 4 of 8 for 48 yards. And all of a sudden now gets a seam downfield, Mulhart. It's an emotional game for him coming from Southern California where he grew up.
Gain of 37. Allen looking to the left side. And again looking for Mulhart. And the coverage. DeMonte KZ. I mean, who else? KZ's been everywhere for San Diego State.
Well, Mulhart is 6'6", Steve. 230 pounds. So KZ's only 5'11". He's given up 7 inches, but great position. And at the right time, we've seen him do this twice already in this game to get that hand up at just the right time to knock the ball.
32 seconds left now. Wyoming scored the first 10. San Diego State has matched them since. Allen feeling some heat. And as he released, he was knocked around. Sergio Phillips found his way in the backfield.
And I don't know if that ball was tipped, but that should be intentional grounding. He was inside the pocket, and there was no receiver anywhere near the area. He got tipped by Sergio Phillips. In that case, there's no intentional grounding.
Yeah. Third and 10. Looks like they need a yard or two to get to that field goal line. 1 of 6 so far in third down conversions. Allen trying to run for it. Can't get there. Cameron Kelly made the tackle. It's a loss. And Allen frustrated. And that clock continues to spin. 15 seconds left in the half.
Yeah, you're losing the opportunity here to at least attempt a field goal. Unless Greg Bohl just wants to let it run down, call a timeout to end the first half.
That was odd.
His young quarterback, his eyes are not staying downfield now. He's seeing the rush. He had open receivers there, but the blitz of Rocky Long is starting to affect Josh Allen.
How many seconds ticked away there? 10, 12 seconds?
I think they wanted, he wanted to run down the clock, and whether he punts it or attempts a field goal, didn't want to leave any time on the clock.
And that's the difference. You heard all the Carson Wentz comparisons. And physically, I think there's a lot that's similar. I would actually say that Allen has a better arm than Carson Wentz. But the difference is that Wentz, with all the additional starts that he had and just more game reps and more experience, really developed the mental aspect of the game. And I think that's where Allen's going to have to grow. Listen, if he develops in that area, he's got a chance to be an early round draft pick and a really good starting quarterback in the league. That's how talented he is. We're not, just making this up because we're doing the game. But he's far away in terms of the little things that you have to do to be great. And that's where Wentz was always special.
Well, Todd, I agree with you, Todd. But, there's a lot of players, a lot of athletes that can throw the ball, that can run. The difference in the NFL, is can you think?
Right.
Can you process information very quickly? Are you tough enough?
He's got a couple years now to try to figure it all out. And he has the right coaching staff around him, too.
I agree. Brent Vegan is a very good offensive coordinator. And I do think Craig Bohl has the right tough mindset to bring along a young player in Josh Allen.
Going to take a shot at the end zone here with 3 seconds left in the first half. Pretty close to that field goal target line. Didn't want to push it. Here's Allen pushing it downfield in the end zone. And it is knocked away. Cameron Kelly. I can still hear Tom Jackson screaming, "Knock it down." And that's exactly what Cameron Kelly did. We're all tied in the Mountain West Championship game. Let's go to the studio and add Dan Burke.
It's Dr. Pepper Championship Week.
Welcome back to ESPN College Football Primetime, presented by Hampton by Hilton. Part of Jimmy V Week for Cancer Research, as we continue our commitment to the V Foundation and Jim Valvano's dream to defeat cancer. 10-all in the Mountain West Championship game here in Laramie, Wyoming. And some of the numbers, none of which really stand out. What do you think, Tex? That first, there were a combined 9 passes that were completed in that first half. These are two defenses that combined to allow 119 points a week ago, but the defenses have come up big in that first half.
Yeah, San Diego State really was able to get some pressure on Josh Allen, force a turnover, and then Wyoming, for the most part, was able to contain Donnell Pumphrey 57 yards in the first half, but we know how explosive he is. They'll have to do it again in the second half.
Wyoming will get the football to start here in the second half. Wyoming scored the first 10 points of the game, and San Diego State was able to rally back. And they will start at the 25-yard line. Down to Chili McShay.
You guys look great in that booth. Josh Allen, first half, some special things. We told you he has a special skill set, and here at 6'5", when he hangs in the pocket, keeps his eyes down the field, he can make throws that a lot of guys in college football cannot. But one issue that he's had in this first half he's going to have to improve upon is when his eyes drop when he's inside the pocket too early. You see right there, he had a wide open receiver and misses him. Just 5 for 12 in the first half. He's got to be better in the second half for Wyoming to win.
Last 5 possessions for Wyoming to end that half. Interception, punt, punt, punt. And the end of the half. So on first down and 10, Brian Hill, the ball carrier, maybe got a yard on forward progress for Calvin Munson. Made the tackle.
This second half for Wyoming offensively cannot just be about Josh Allen. They have got to get Brian Hill going. People think he's been overlooked because of Donnell Pumphrey in this conference, but he's the 4th leading rusher in college football this year, and they have to get more production. And this offensive line up front, we haven't talked a whole lot about them, but their senior captain Chase Roulier at center has to motivate this offensive line to block better in the second half.
Well, Pumphrey's been held to 57 yards on the ground. Hill just 22 yards, 2 yards per carry. Here's Allen throwing, and he sailed it over the head of Tanner Gentry.
Rocky Long has got to be happy with the way that his defense has adjusted. You know, they came in, as we mentioned, last week against Colorado State, 63 points. And for them to come in and play as well as they have in the first part of this game, it's an encouraging sign for Rocky Long.
1 of 7 so far on third down conversions. They've been pretty good all season. You saw 46%, but not tonight, not to this point. With four receivers in the pattern for Josh Allen, trying to spin out of some trouble. And throw it out of the field. It's a jump ball, and it's intercepted. It's KZ again, his second interception of the night. And that's how the first possession goes of the second half for the Cowboys.
This is exactly what Craig Bohl does not want to see from his young quarterback. And you know they talked about it at halftime. There's KZ over here. You're going to roll. There's a corner blitz coming, but you cannot throw this ball late like this across your body. He did it. The problem is he does it against Boise State, gets away with it. He did it in the first game against San Diego State and gets away with it. And when you get away with it and you have a big arm, it's just too enticing. And he wasn't able to lay off of it, Todd.
And one of the reasons you don't throw across your body is because you're not set physically and your fundamentals, your footwork's not right. You saw that ball did not come out of his hand the way any other throw has the remainder of the night.
Yeah, you can't see, Todd. You can't see back there. And he obviously didn't see Casey.
Here's Pumphrey trying to turn the corner and get outside. And he has just enough for the first down. As for Casey, he has 17 career interceptions now. Think about that. 7 this season. But the 17 career interceptions is a school record and is tied among all active FBS players with Weston Steelhammer of Air Force. First down and 10 after the 11-yard run. Chapman's under center, and he'll pitch to Pumphrey. Cuts it back the other way. Now near side, and he'll be pushed out of the 12-yard line.
Is there a quicker back in college football? I mean, take a look at this real speed. I mean, this... pretty awesome. Trust, you know, he trusts his offensive line, trusts his coaches. He's been through so much in his career, and he's just playing with an extreme amount of confidence right now.
Pumphrey out, Penny in on 2nd and 2. I take a shot in 2nd and 2, as you know, please. Hand off. It's Penny right up the middle. Has the first down, and that'll move the chains. Bring up a 1st and goal.
You know, one of the differences I've noticed as the season has gone on for San Diego State is they have spelled Pumphrey more with Penny. And I think it keeps Donnell fresher. Yes, he's had over 300 carries. A lot of those were front-loaded at the beginning of the season. But as Penny has emerged, I think Donnell Pumphrey has gotten better because he's been fresher.
131 rushing yards as a team for the Aztecs tonight. Here on 1st and goal. Penny stays in there. Gets some blocking from the fullback, Bawden, and leaps into the end zone for the touchdown. Rashad Penny. And the Aztecs make the Cowboys pay. Turnover and the score.
You want to talk about the maturity of these two teams. The immaturity in the case of Josh Allen throwing the interception, and then the maturity of the San Diego State team, who has been in this position before. Last year in the Mountain West Conference and under Rocky Long quite a few times, winning a bunch of games to be physical and make them pay off the turnover with a physical run game.
And Chapman doesn't have to put it in the air. 4 plays all on the ground. San Diego State, as we wait for the extra point, I think they're going to take a look. See where that knee was down.
Reestablishing that line of scrimmage. Like that elbow, the question, that left elbow was down, and by rule he is down. The question is, where is the football when that left elbow went down? Had it crossed the plane yet or not? But you want to talk about reestablishing the line of scrimmage. I mean, he had 6-7 yards before he even got touched. And you remember what Jeff Horton was telling us yesterday about, you know, the effect that a 2-yard run in the first quarter then has in the third quarter in establishing that physical presence that Rocky Long so covets. We see the first drive of the third quarter, punch it in.
But they didn't get as many snaps as they wanted to. Last game, they had a 22-snap disadvantage. It was 86 snaps, I believe, for Wyoming and just 64 for San Diego State. They had about 32-33 in the first half, so they want to have possessed the ball a lot more in the second half.
Well, a big reason for that, too, Todd, was because they had the 2 kickoff return for touchdowns. So
right.
It took away 2 possessions, so, you know, obviously you'll take that. But they weren't able to establish that physical run attack and wear down on the defensive line.
Penny, who has gotten the most of his opportunities as a special teamer, the Mountain West Special Teams Performer of the Year. That was just announced this week. And having to take a back seat to Donnell Pumphrey. It's a pretty good back seat to have. And all this will be yours next year. And Penny, we asked about the sleeves in the cold weather. He goes, nope. They will be sleeves-less. That was Jeff Horton's rule, the offensive coordinator.
Yeah, well, I think that's probably every offensive coach will not allow their receivers or backs to wear sleeves because it increases their likelihood to fumble the football because the cloth moves. I had guys that used to put Vaseline on their arms, though. I was like, how do you hold on to the ball with Vaseline on you? I mean, I understand it makes you warmer and more difficult to tackle, but...
Did you wear gloves, Grease? Tell the truth.
No, man.
One glove?
They only made gloves for big guys.
After further review, the ruling on the field stands. Touchdown.
It's pretty good luxury for Rocky Long, as you mentioned, to have the special teams player of the year in the Mountain West, backing up the offensive player of the year of the Mountain West, and the interception by the defensive player of the Mountain West.
Penny. His 15th touchdown of the season, 10th on the ground. And the extra point from John Barron is good. With 5 minutes left in the first quarter, it was 10-0 Wyoming. And then the pick by DeMonte KZ. And that turns into points, 17-10, visiting San Diego State. Back in Laramie, Wyoming, San Diego State has never had consecutive 10-win seasons as a member of a Division I conference. Trying to get that here tonight. And they are on top now of the Cowboys, 17-10. And we are eager to see how young Josh Allen responds to his latest interception throw. That'll go out the back of the end zone. We'll start at the 25-yard line.
Yeah, if you're Brent Vegan, their offensive coordinator, you've got to settle your young quarterback down. He's been the reason that you're in this game in the first place, his playmaking ability, but his decision-making and aggressive nature has led to those 2 interceptions, both of which have hurt this Cowboys team. But the problem is you don't have a real running game to rely on, at least in this game. Brian Hill's been great all year, but in this game he has really been bottled up, only 22 yards on the ground.
Josh Allen has just 5 completed. You know, the interceptions are one thing, but he's just 5 for 14 passing to this point. He's in some trouble now. Allen able to get away with it and throw it to Brian Hill. That's one way of getting some yardage and out of trouble.
That's great improv. It's a broken play. They wanted to throw a double move on the outside. And there was nothing there. We didn't give up on the play. Great job by Brian Hill of bailing his quarterback out.
And he stayed patient with it, Allen did. You know, his eyes did drop when the rush came, but then he quickly got him back up, located, didn't panic there. I think that was the difference in that play.
So a little breathing room and maybe a deep breath as well for Josh Allen. Come with some pressure. Now it is swung around and brought down by Calvin Munson.
For a loss, 54.
This is the pressure Rocky Long has brought all game. Right here, you're going to see Munson. They're going to come with a little cross-dog blitz, and you got to get rid of the football here. You can't hold on to it. But Rocky Long is taking the game to Josh Allen. He's not going to allow him just to sit back there and pick you apart. I think it's been the best adjustment Rocky Long has made from the previous game to this one.
Give Munson 100 tackles on the season. Second and 15 after the loss. Here they come again. And there he goes again. Allen is dropped. This time it's Sergio Phillips.
And to Todd's point, the head is of Josh Allen's going down. He's taking about two steps, and then that head goes down. And as soon as the defense sees that, they are just going to continue to bring pressure. Brett Vegan, the offensive coordinator, Craig, will need to help him out. You can't take five-step drops right now. Whether you want to or not, you got to get rid of the football. Call some quick passing for your young quarterback.
Consecutive sacks by that San Diego State defense. The first two sacks of the game by either team. Third and 21 with four on the play clock. Wyoming has to burn a timeout there. Got out of the huddle way too late. We'll be right back.
The 2016 Mountain West Football Championship game, brought to you by Dr. Pepper. It's a college football tradition and the Lincoln Wish List sales event.
Hey, look at the old Wyoming Territorial Prison here in Laramie, built in 1872. It once was the home of Butch Cassidy. Now, it wasn't apparently one of the more secure prisons. Their completion percentage, not great. 11 of the 44 prisoners jailed in its first 2 years escaped. 11 of 44, Grease. Can't believe they closed that place down. That's roughly 25%, roughly.
It was a time, you know, late 1800s, time of lawlessness, you know?
11 of 44. Crime did pay back then. Third and 21 as we come back. Little dump off. Brian Hill couldn't come up with that, and if he had, he would have been in big trouble. Noble Hall made the hit.
It was the right call, safe call, third and long.
Now one of nine on third down conversion.
Yeah, this team's got to be careful. Wyoming's got to be careful in this situation here. You got quarterback who's got his head down. You got a running back just got hit, his head's down. Somebody on this Wyoming team has to step up and lead.
Quest Truxton will call for the fair catch at the 41 yard line.
They're getting another shot at Donnell Pumphrey. Great blocking up front all night. Bunn converted quarterback to fullback into the spin move, but it hasn't all been Pumphrey. He's got an assist from Shad Penny as well, but when he's fresh and he doesn't have to shoulder all the load and he gets to the perimeter, his lateral movement, it's been a lot of fun to watch this kid play the last 4 years, and it's really his career coming to a close here this game, and they'll have one more. But we'll miss watching Donnell Pumphrey.
See, 24 yards away from passing Ricky Williams, the second on the all-time list, and then he can set his sights on Ron Dane. Flags fly. Wyoming's last seven possessions, Grease, 26 total snaps.
False start. Offense number 19. 5 yard penalty, first down.
That's Pumphrey.
Just when we start talking about him, he jumps off sides. Mm-hmm.
Well, you were surprised at the lack of communication, though, on the sideline with the young quarterback struggling.
Yeah, with Wyoming and Josh Allen. Brett Vegan, the offensive coordinator, is up in the booth, and a lot of people choose to do that. The one thing you lose when you do that is being able to look in a guy's eye and settle him down. Get a read from him. What do you see? What do you not see? Let's calm down and get this thing going. And that's what Josh Allen needs right now.
Pitch to Pumphrey. Barely gets back to the line of scrimmage. Rico Gafford stepped up to fill the hole. And it's not as if Christian Chapman is lighting things up. Chapman's 4-for-10 passing in this game, but he's got a 7-point lead.
No, but that's what Christian Chapman has been asked to do in this offense. You know, throw the ball 15, 16 times max. And, they won the Mountain West Championship a year ago with 14 pass attempts. So he's kind of right where he needs to be. The bigger surprise is Wyoming, who likes to throw a little bit.
They don't want him to turn it over. He's only turned it over once in the game. He's been pretty steady all season long. Lucas Walker comes up to make the tackle, the younger brother of Cardinals pitcher Michael Walker.
Walker's so good with his eyes and the way he reads things. I watched tape leading up, we all did. He's constantly the first guy to react to the ball and where it goes. He makes his initial key and diagnose the offensive lineman, but then his eyes immediately get to the backfield, finds the ball, and he's the first one there consistently. He's made a lot of plays tonight.
He's done a great job too, Todd, of taking over that leadership role for DJ May, who's out for this game.
Third and 12. Chapman has plenty of time, now on the run. And he won't get anywhere near that first down marker. Kevin Prosser able to bring him down.
Give some credit, yeah, give some credit to this Wyoming defense. They are last in the conference in total defense, and they have come in, flipped the script, and they are supporting this Wyoming offense, keeping them in the game in the second half.
Austin Conway is back deep to receive the punt. Tanner Blaine, what a 75-yard earlier. Conway is driven back. He'll be dropped at about the 11-yard line. Get another look at Josh Allen. See if Wyoming has figured things out on offense when we come back. Take a look at tonight's Aflac trivia question. Never want to cut you off. Who's the only player from the Mountain West Conference to be selected number one overall in the NFL draft?
Oh, that's an easy one.
All right. Yeah. We'll let you folks at home think about it. Everybody's all locked in on that one. Fire the guy who came up with the question this week. A little too simple, apparently. All right, here we go. First down and 10 for Wyoming. This equals their best starting field position. Wow. Their worst starting field position. They haven't had any good starting field position all night. Allen, and things are going to get worse for him. Taken down by Kyle Kelly, and now he might be hurt.
Come on, he got stepped on. Looked like Noble Hall came over there. He was on the ground, and to make that injury to insult, I think Noble Hall stepped on him. I think it may have been by accident, but take a big sack, and he's on the ground. There's Kelly, 59, but watch 95 come over to celebrate, and he comes down right on the leg of Josh Allen. Yeah,
they got to snap this football down to 2. They just get it away after the big loss of 9. Big run by Brian Hill, finally breaks free. Here's Hill down the sideline, and only KZ, of course, is able to knock him down. Brian Hill, we've been waiting for that all night.
Rocky Long brought another pressure. Cameron Kelly, the safety, came off the edge, and he was responsible. But he did not get Brian Hill on the ground. And we talked about taking the pressure off your quarterback. One of the best ways to do it is run the football.
That's 66 yards on the run by Brian Hill. By far his biggest of the night. Prior to that run, they had 3 sacks in the previous 4 snaps. So they needed that desperately. Sean Wick now checks in. Give Hill a breather. But Allen's going to throw. Far side of the field. Too far for Josh Harshman, the tight end.
Todd, I want to ask you, if you're Brett Vegan, what are you going to do to settle this quarterback down and get this offense back in rhythm?
Well, San Diego State has a 3-man front. When they're sending pressure, they've done a lot of it, they're sending 2 guys, usually to one side. And to be honest with you, it's been easy pre-snap to figure out which 2 guys are coming. So now you've got to figure out, with the zone coverage behind it, where's the vacated zone and start attacking that spot.
Second and 10. It's Sean Wick, the ball carrier. Maybe a yard on the play. Third down.
What I don't know is how much, they said that he has control with setting his protections and checking out of bad plays, but how much control in terms of hot reads and what their adjustments can be based off the blitz, right?
Yeah, one of the things you can do, rather than trying to pick up all the blitz as a quarterback, is as an offensive coordinator, spread the defense out and throw the ball quick. We haven't called Tanner Gentry's name in two quarters. Mulhall,
good point.
Jacob Hollister, none of these guys have catches. They're not in the ball game. Give them some opportunity to throw the ball quick.
And they can't convert on third down. 1-9. Make it 1-10. There's C.J. Johnson for the short game. Calvin Munson having himself a football game tonight.
Now they're in that fringe area where Craig Bohl's got to make a decision on fourth and five, and made a pretty quick one to bring Cooper Roth, a true freshman, on to attempt a field goal. He's hit six in a row going back to the Boise game. And made one here tonight already, 46 yards.
That 46-yarder equals his career high. This is from 42. The short goalposts here. No good. Missed it.
That one's on Greasy.
He's a true freshman and been pretty reliable. Looked like this was online, Steve, and then just took a hard left turn. And that big run by Brian Hills goes for no points.
We were expecting big wins tonight to really impact the game, but that has not been the case. And that can't be an excuse on that missed field goal.
Once again, this Wyoming defense put out there with no room for error, down seven in this game.
San Diego State with the lead and the football. Rashad Penny is the setback. And he's got the ball. Penny trying to make some people miss and does. Was able to beat Rico Gafford to the corner, and then only Marcus Epps able to force him out. But not until he had the big game.
He may not have the quickness that we see from Donnell, but man, he's got speed to get to the outside. That's one cut and go, and he's hard to track down from behind.
Oh, and he's 220 pounds too, Todd. I mean, it's going to be a sad day for San Diego State fans when Donnell Pumphrey goes on to the next level. But this guy, Rashad Penny, the future is bright next season, where he's going to get a heavy part of the load of this offense run to football.
Ripped off 37 there. Pumphrey's back in the game now. And he takes it right up the middle for six.
Starting to see this offensive line and tight end start to lean on the defensive front for Wyoming. This is their game. You know, they will stick with it. They are conservative. Jeff Horton comes from a conservative line of coaching. Big guys up front. You see the size, 330. Saragusa is probably the best of all of them. Really starting to reestablish the line of scrimmage.
185 rushing yards behind that offensive line. Pumphrey has 84, Petty has 80. And Pumphrey's going to lose there. Loss on the play, loss of two. Logan Wilson on the stop.
First time we've mentioned Logan Wilson. So what is the adjustment for Wyoming on the defensive side? You got to get, there hasn't been a whole lot of passing. You got to get that ninth guy in the box, Steve. And when you get him there, you got to get Donnell Pumphrey and Rashad Penny on the ground. We've seen Wingert miss tackles, Epps miss tackles. That's been the key in the game.
Here's third and six. Two to snap it. One. Did he get the timeout in time? He did. San Diego State burns their first timeout of the second half. Back in Laramie, we answer our Aflac trivia question tonight. We asked earlier, who's the only player from the Mountain West Conference we selected number one overall in the NFL draft? You guys want to shout it out at the same time?
Alex Smith.
Alex Smith, yeah. I was just going to say,
I don't think Greasy would have gotten that. Alex Smith,
I'm there for him.
Of Utah, he was the 2004 Mountain West Player of the Year. Finished fourth in the Heisman Trophy voting. He was 21-1 as a starter for the Utes.
He was fresh on my mind. I just watched him beat my Broncos last week. So
third and six as we come back from the timeout. handed off to Pumphrey. And he has the first down. There is a flag in the secondary. We'll check the marker.
San Diego State offensive linemen think it's on Wyoming.
Holding. Defense number 87. 10-yard penalty will be added to the end of the run. First down.
Connor Kane, the sophomore from Littleton, Colorado.
It's a pretty good position to be in when you're third and seven and you can just turn around, hand the football off, reestablish the line of scrimmage and get a first down. I mean, that is the recipe for Jeff Horton and for Rocky Long on offense.
Pumphrey needed 8 yards to pass Ricky Williams. We'll see where that second effort winds up.
You know, San Diego State had a great fullback a year ago in Dakota Gordon, and Nick Baud, as we mentioned, talked about him in the first half. Can't say enough about him at now 6'3", 240 pounds. He's made the move from quarterback to fullback, and he is absolutely killing the linebackers for Wyoming.
Pumphrey a yard shy. Here it is, has the yard and then some. Just put Ricky Williams in the rearview mirror. And Danelle Pumphrey takes over second on the all-time rushing yards list in college football.
How about that? I mean, that's... And it could be a nicer kid. Could not be a nicer kid. And humble, but driven. He's been a leader for 4 years at this program. And it's good to see. You know, and he's got that one game left. Who knows? He could do it this game. He breaks a couple big runs, but well within his range to catch Ron Dane before his career's out.
2 minutes left here in the third quarter. On third and one, Wyoming thinks they stop Pumphrey. This would be very close.
Looks like he had to get to the 5-yard line. And by the replay we had, didn't look like he got there. Looks like he got a generous spot.
Call for a measurement.
We had a look from over top in our sky cam that showed that he got a favorable spot there. It did not look like he got anywhere near the 5-yard line.
Wow.
That's a first down.
That's fourth down. That's by the size of your credit card.
Well, I think it ends up being the right call because, look, I don't think he gets a favorable spot. See if you think he gets to the 5-yard line right there.
Nope.
Looks like Michigan, Ohio State there.
I wasn't going to bring it up. Yeah. Glad you did.
They're going to go for it, though. And why not? I mean, they have been completely blowing Wyoming off the ball.
There's a good look from the sky cam. Top of Arthur Flores. Got some extra big bodies up front. Here's Petty. First down and touchdown as well. Imposing their will, which San Diego State said they want to do in the fourth quarter. Looks like they've done it here late in the third.
Great effort there by Penny. Wyoming had Logan Wilson free, completely free in the hole, and he's just not able to get Rashard Penny on the ground. Wilson goes 225 and Penny's 220, and he's able to get skinny in the hole and get a big conversion and then finish with a touchdown.
They checked it out, all good. Longest drive tonight, 75 yards. Here's John Barron to add the exclamation point. 75 yards, and that's their formula as well. Christian Chapman didn't throw it a single time.
Yep.
On a 75-yard drive.
They're now over 200 yards on the ground. And it's the mix of Donnell Pumphrey and Rashard Penny. But look at these blocks up front. The offensive line, the physicality. Bodden at fullback, you see there, gets another block. Siragusa, Flores up front. It's been an impressive adjustment here in the second half as San Diego State has really begun to let their horses run.
How far is Las Vegas from San Diego? It's not that far.
No.
Sounds like all the people we've spoken to, the Las Vegas Bowl will select the winner of this game here tonight as one representative. And there's a lot of speculation out there now that Houston will be the other choice for the Las Vegas Bowl.
It's interesting bowl season, you know. The Cactus Bowl is going to come into the Mountain West as well, because I don't think there will be enough bowl eligible teams from the Pac-12 to fill that, so they'll probably get the second pick in the Mountain West after the Las Vegas Bowl.
That's why you got to tune in noon Eastern time tomorrow. Reese Davis and all the guys, selection show. Also tomorrow, gonna push it up a little earlier because of the college football selection show. Get your NFL started off on the right foot. 9 a.m. Eastern, NFL Insider Sunday edition with Trey Wingo and company. Then at 10, it's Chris Berman of the best in the business for Sunday NFL Countdown. And this Monday night, it will in fact be Andrew Luck and the Indianapolis Colts taking on Brandon Marshall of the Jets. 8:15 Eastern. Coverage begins Monday Night Countdown, served by Applebee's at 6 p.m. Eastern. The Jets have not been mathematically eliminated, by the way.
How are you feeling about your
playoff competition? I'm just saying, mathematically, they are still alive.
Emotionally, have you eliminated them?
I have checked out and started looking at the draft and see what McShay has for early first-round picks. Minute 13 to play here in the third. There's an injured player down on the sideline. It looks like it's Drew Van Maun, and he was the ball carrier there.
They made a great catch, a one-handed stab on the bootleg pass, and went down awkward on the sideline. Van Maun, and much like Bowden for San Diego State, the physical presence in the run game at the fullback position for Wyoming. See what happened at the end of this play. Great catch.
Yeah.
Concentration. That's Casey that comes up. Boy, that's a scary look there. Is his head, the front part of his head, the crown of his helmet goes right into the ground. Looked like he was dazed on the field for a split second there. That's Munson, 54, that comes, and it's a legal hit there. But anytime that helmet hits the ground, that ground doesn't give. And
especially not tonight.
Nope, it's a little cooler.
Being attended to on that San Diego State sideline. Van Maunen is a junior from Parker, Colorado.
When watching, I was talking about Van Maunen yesterday, watching him on tape last couple of weeks, been one of my favorite players to watch for Wyoming on the offensive side. Gives 150% effort on every single play. He's a bulldozer. He reminds me like a Tasmanian devil out there. Mm-hmm. He'll go pancake somebody, hop up, run downfield, hit somebody else. Never gives up. And I asked Calvin Munson, the linebacker for San Diego State, about him. He said he loves playing against him. He's got ultimate respect for him as a competitor. And good to see him up and back. There's Munson right there, giving him a little high five.
Criminal justice major. He's got the high motor.
He's got a strawberry blonde mohawk too, so he's got the fashion.
Good visual. Now, with any luck, he's feeling fine. He'll take the helmet off. So he'll check out of the game. We'll keep an eye on him. Minute 13 to play here in the third quarter. Second and two for Wyoming. Leading 24, we're trailing 24 to 10. Kyle Kelly, made the stop. They will give him the first down. It was very close. Brian Hill got the necessary two. And that will keep the drive alive.
So last drive, they got the big run from Brian Hill. Got down into the red zone area, not able to convert. Missed the field goal. You're getting to that point in the game, down 14. You know, we're getting to the end of the third quarter where time's running out for Wyoming. They have got to get something going on offense. They haven't had nothing since the first quarter.
Want to get this crowd back in the game. Those that have braved the elements here tonight. Here's Al to throw. Put some touch on that one. And they're across midfield at Tyree Mayfield's first grab. As we check in with that in Denver. Adnan, thanks. Felt like forever since Allen's last completion. Good for 15 there on first down and 10. Here's Brian Hill trying to pick a spot. Instead, he's sent flying backwards. Loss on the play, and that's how quarter number three will come to an end. Seems like a long time ago, Wyoming scored the first 10 points of the game. Ever since then, 24 unanswered by the Aztecs on our way to the fourth. Welcome back to ESPN College Football Primetime, presented by Hampton by Hilton as part of Dr. Pepper Championship Week. San Diego State defense, they bounced back nicely ever since they allowed 97 points in their last two games.
Yeah, and it's been this attacking style from Rocky Long, and it's been a lot of the months in their senior linebacker and captain, number 54. You see him coming in a lot of different sets. They've been bringing some stunts up front. They are not allowing Josh Allen the time to survey the field, and this approach has really gave them an opportunity to be up two touchdowns in this game.
Levy, Greasy McShay, and our outstanding college football crew from Laramie, Wyoming. For a lot of us, our first visit, and enjoying every second. We open up quarter number four just across midfield, and the Cowboys need something here on second and nine. Allen the pump, and now a throw the other side of the field, and able to complete. Mulhart coming over to make a play for his quarterback.
Yeah, extends the play here. Key is don't throw back across your body. You're going to roll right, throw to the outside where you know you can use your strong arm and protect the football.
Not many guys can make that throw as quickly getting the ball from A to B as he did. But I like the idea, the concept of throwing vertically. You know, these corners are sitting on a lot of routes. I saw a double route on the backside. I think they'll continue to do that.
Mulhart's second catch. Got 52 receiving yards. Here's Brian Hill trying to pick up some blockers. Not much doing there. What's happening back in the studio? Here's Adnan. All right, two touchdown lead. Not a blowout by any means. Keep an eye on that one. Here it's a two touchdown lead as well.
It's got to get points here if you're Wyoming.
Allen hit as he throws, has a man, and could not hook up with his intended target. Malik Smith got a knock on Allen.
Great pickup on the inside. We talked a lot about the blitz. Take a look at Brian Hill picking up the blitz on the inside. You had the matchup you wanted, a wide receiver on the outside, and they had Kyle Kelly, a defensive tackle basically at 260 pounds, running downfield with the wide receiver.
Hey, I'm gonna keep hitting it until they get one, Grease. 1 for 10 on third down conversions. Here's Allen. Back by the 50. And now he'll throw it. Show you the arm strength. End zone. Back in the end zone. Caught. Touchdown. Tanner Gentry went up to make the grab. Allen in in all sorts of trouble, and now Wyoming's back in the game.
Josh Allen had Gentry open early in this play. It looked like there was a breakdown in coverage. Gentry was streaking down the seam. Didn't see him initially, and then comes back to him, and it does a nice job, Gentry does, of getting away with a push-off and creating some late separation, Brock.
Well, Todd, they had a true freshman, Trenton Thompson, who I haven't seen play a whole lot this season, and he's the one that busted the coverage and tried to make up for it, but he got there too late, and the arm strength of Josh Allen, 53 yards down the field on the run. That's a hose.
Extra point is good. I got a quick statistical question for you, Greece. Does that count as a third down conversion?
Absolutely.
Hey, how about 2 for 11 on third down in a big way? That touchdown was Wyoming's first points in exactly 36 minutes. I mean, to the second. They took a 10-0 lead. And they find themselves now right back in the football game. Plenty of time left, 13:49 left here in the fourth quarter, trailing by a touchdown.
Yeah, they had to have it. I mean, this Wyoming team, and in particular Josh Allen, in crunch time, fourth quarter against Boise and fourth quarter against San Diego State 2 weeks ago, that's been the time where they have really come alive and played their best.
Penny and Washington both dying to get a return. Both of that kickoff returns for touchdowns against Wyoming. Won't get an opportunity here.
And we mentioned that game 2 weeks ago. Very similar look here. This is Josh Allen creating, rolling to his right, and then heaving downfield. This one was to Ballhart, which led to a touchdown on the next play. And this is that last third down. Very similar look. He loves to roll right and then trust that arm and just gives his wide receivers an opportunity. And that time it's Gentry. That's been a big part of Josh Allen's game this season. He's got supreme confidence in that arm. It's been great for him at times, and it's been a detriment at times, as we've seen early in the first half.
Well, that's the classic from the sideline. No, 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 no. Yes, 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 yes. And it's a 7-point game. We'll see what the Wyoming defense can do here. Danelle Pumphrey up over 100 yards. He'll watch Christian Chapman throw it down the field and complete. Micah Holder, and I can't remember the last time Chapman completed a pass.
Great call here from Jeff Horton. It's been all runs the entire third quarter, not one pass from Christian Chapman. 15 plays, all runs, and they open the fourth quarter with a play-action pass and get a big first down and seize momentum.
Marty said Chapman's last completion was early in the second quarter, and they've been winning the whole game via the runs you mentioned, Greece. Here's Pumphrey. Marcus Epps, the stop. That's a loss of one.
Marcus Epps.
It's like Ricky Williams back in the conversation. Needed 100 yards tonight to pass Ricky.
Second down, 10 yards.
We'll call it a loss of one. So he's still there,
but so he's still
cutting
ahead.
It close. Second and 11. Upcoming.
Steve, when you have safeties making tackles for loss, what does that tell you?
It tells you got problems.
No, you should be throwing the football, right? If the safeties.
Well, they're up. They're so close to the line of scrimmage.
You got to be able to throw the play action pass.
Second and 11.
And you got problems.
Chapman's throwing again.
Chapman's
and incomplete.
That's what they're trying. That's what they're trying to do.
Yeah.
I mean, two of the last three plays, they know that the safeties are biting, and they have to. That's the only way Wyoming's going to stop the run. So now it's time to exploit it.
Yeah, and they made the throw and catch, Todd, on the first play to Micah Holder. That time they tried to get the football to Kendrick Mathis, who hasn't played a whole lot this season for San Diego State, and they just missed the connection.
Third down and 11. Crowd getting loud. Chapman, a little dump off to Penny. Not enough. Wyoming's defense will get off the field. Marcus Epps comes up to make the tackle.
Nice tackle in the open field by Marcus Epps. It's not an easy man, Rashad Penny, to get on the ground. Epps now two big plays on this drive. In the last game against San Diego State, he had 12 tackles. So he loves playing against the Aztecs.
Now, when your safeties are your leading tacklers, Greece, Epps and Wingard are, that tells me they're usually getting into your secondary. You'd like your linebackers to be leading in tackles. Austin Conway call for the fair catch. And Wyoming gets the football back. And they will start at their own 12-yard line, trailing by seven.
The 2016 Mountain West Football Championship game is presented by Hampton by Hilton. Book at Hampton.com for a guaranteed discount. And in part by Hyundai.
Under 12 to play in a one-score game in the Mountain West Football Championship game. A reminder, fans, Star Wars Rogue One is in theaters on December the 16th.
You gonna go see that?
That's just around the corner.
The kids are big Star Wars fans. We did the whole six movies, like,
at one time?
In a week.
Oh.
No, not at one time. Jeez.
My mom once dropped me off for Planet of the Apes, all five in a row. She left me in the theater, and after five straight Planet of the Apes, she picked me up.
Were you that hard to deal with?
Apparently so.
Probably a great day for mom.
I was 5 years old at the time. On first down and 10, here's Allen to throw. Down the middle. Oh, and it was dropped. Tanner Gentry, who goes up and gets the ball as well as anyone in the conference, couldn't hang on to that one.
Yeah, he's made a career in Wyoming, making these tough grabs in traffic. Ball's a little bit high. It's a nice route, but Tanner Gentry normally comes down with that football, as we saw in the last touchdown. Well thrown football.
Second and 10 after the long incompletion. Head off to Brian Hill, leans forward for a yard. Adnan, what do you got? All right, Adnan, thank you. A couple of Penn State alums in the booth reacting to that in different ways. Third down and 9. Remember the last third down conversion by Josh Allen was that 33-yard touchdown pass.
We're going to get a timeout here from Craig Bohl. We had a substitution miscommunication, and on a big third and 9, backed up. Takes a timeout.
That could be critical. Leave them with just one.
See, there's some miscommunication on the outside. Mulhart was trying to get back in the game. Kind of how you expected this game to go?
Well, we thought it would be a close game.
Yeah.
We thought it would be a competitive game, and why wouldn't we think that after just 2 weeks ago they played a one-point game here, and that was a thriller. It's interesting. We talked to the coaches, and one side said, hey, we'd like to see this game played in the 30s.
Yeah.
And then the other side said, we'd like to see, we're more comfortable with this game in the 20s.
San Diego State that wanted to play in the 30s, which was interesting. But the defenses, I think, have been the story so far. We thought that San Diego State would make some adjustments with Rocky Long. They've done that, and they've contained Wyoming for the most part outside of the big play that they just gave up on the third down. But Wyoming defense has really surprised me the way that they've played.
What's this conversation about?
Well, Rocky's probably asking them about this substitution, but it doesn't matter if you call a timeout. Kind of your get out of jail free card.
I got a feeling they got to need that timeout, right? Down to one, trailing by a touchdown in the fourth quarter. That's what Josh Allen has done on third down. No first downs, just a couple touchdowns.
Yep. Expect more pressure here from San Diego State.
Allen trying to step up. There is a flag behind the play. Allen puts his head down, and the football goes down as well. Lost the football. San Diego State says they have it, and they do. Kyle Kelly. Looks like he came up with it. We'll check the flag. And that might be the play of the game right there.
Boy. Josh Allen, when you have to put all of the playmaking on your quarterback, you don't have any run game to support him, he feels like he has to do everything. He's fighting and scratching to try to get a first down, and great job by Henderson. Jay Henderson, the junior, number 46, gets his hand on that football and rips. That is textbook as a linebacker comes up with a huge turnover.
Henderson knocked it free, Kelly recovered. And for Josh Allen, that's his third turnover tonight. Two interceptions, and now the fumble.
And Craig Bohl, we were talking with him yesterday, and we just saw him in the office casually walking by his young quarterback, and he looked at me, and he said, hey, can you talk to him? Tell him to protect the football. And it's a high wire act right now with Josh Allen. He makes some unbelievable plays, and he gets guys, you know, excited about his arm and all that, but then the turnovers have killed them today.
What a tackle by Marcus Epps.
Pumphrey carries back to the 20-yard line.
On Pumphrey.
Marcus Epps.
All that being said, sudden change as a defense. Wyoming has been put here on the 20-yard line. They have an opportunity. They've got to try to force at least a field goal attempt. But this offensive line for San Diego State has just been pushing them off the ball.
12 tackles on the night for Epps. Second down and 8. Here's Chapman on the run. Gonna keep running. And he has shoved out of bounds in a big way by Logan Wilson. Sent him flying.
So far, so good. Logan Wilson pushes him out. Wyoming sets up a big, biggest third down of the game so far. From San Diego State. Might think about trying to get the football to David Wells. They haven't really got him involved. He's a big tight end. Hasn't done a whole lot in this game. No catches. But he's a reliable target. 20 catches on the year.
And a timeout taken by San Diego State. Each team has been reduced to one timeout. Critical play call when we come back. Just in time, Adnan, thank you, for third down and 7.
Be an interesting call here, Steve. I wouldn't be shocked if Jeff Horton, Rocky Long decide to run this football, think they can get a first down. If not, kick a field goal and go up 2 scores.
Well within John Barron's field goal range. Chapman to throw, and then he's going to take off and run it himself and has the first down. How about Christian Chapman running for the first down?
Well, the first thing they needed to do was the disguise. They take Donnell Pumphrey out of the formation. Then they lead up with Bowden, the fullback, who gets just enough of the linebacker to get Chapman the first down.
Great play call, great timing. This is the first time we've seen it all night. And to be honest, in a couple games watching leading up, I have not seen a quarterback draw. So great timing on that breaking tendency.
Well, you got to respect Pumphrey, Todd, you know, when they take him out of the formation.
Absolutely.
Because they throw it to him quite a bit.
Needed 7, got 7. Christian Chapman on the ground. And on first down, here's Pumphrey. Good second effort. Looked like a 1-yard gain turned into an 8-yard gain.
He gets so low that it's almost impossible as a defender, a linebacker, defensive back to get as low as him. And he just sneaks under would-be tacklers. It was amazing to see how low he got and then was able to pop back out.
Second down. Reminds you like of a Darren Sproles or one of the smaller running backs at the NFL at the next level, keeps his legs going. He's not afraid. He's not afraid to get hit, but he rarely gets hit square because he's so elusive.
Pumphrey out, Penny in on 2nd and 3. Can get a first down. Little hesitation move by Penny. And he'll pick up one on the play and bring up a third down to short. Again, they can get the first down as the clock winds. Coming up on 8 minutes to play here in the fourth quarter. San Diego State trying to make it a two-score game.
And at this point, you know, you almost would rather get a first down so you can continue to burn more of the clock. Rocky Long and this staff are probably, of all the teams in college football, more aware of time of possession and value time of possession and number of plays more than anybody.
Rashad Penny already has two rushing touchdowns tonight. We'll try to make it a third. Not that time. Not going to happen. Johanna Gunfar able to make the tackle in the middle of that line.
Boy, give credit to Gaffon. Number 93 is going to spin back off of the block down. That is well done by a defensive tackle. That power play, they teach the tackle to block down on you. And as soon as you feel that, you spin off, and that back should be right in the hole. And defensive coordinator Stan Stannard coached him up well.
20-yard field goal attempt for John Barron. He's made his last six. He's made his last 16 field goal attempts, less than 51 yards. Look, a bit of an issue on the high snap. But Barron's able to bang that one through. So the turnover leads to points. It's not six. It is three. Makes it a two-score game. Getting late in Laramie.
It is true that every team has its own road to the college football playoff. But after all the season's twists and turns, only four teams make it to the end. The College Football Playoff Selection Show, Sunday, December 4th on ESPN.
A whole lot of interested folks tuning in tomorrow based on what has already transpired, certainly last night, Washington, and what happens tonight. And what took place earlier today around college football on this championship Saturday. Should be a fun watch with Reese and company. Whole lot of questions. Get a whole lot of answers. We'll see how many people are upset with those answers. Take a look at this week's college football playoff rankings. Brought to you by PlayStation.
Well, really, it's just one question. I mean, if Clemson continues to lead Virginia Tech and seals that, they're in. And really, there's only one question remaining, and that's Washington. And their non-conference schedule, obviously, that it was very close, razor thin between them and Michigan. And what does the committee decide to do? I still think Michigan is one of the top four teams in the country. I think we know that based on how they played Ohio State. Question is, does the committee, how are they going to? The real question needs to be, and I want to hear from Todd on this too, is are you going to overlook the non-conference schedule of Washington? They play Portland and Idaho State. Or Portland State and Idaho, sorry. It's a big catch by Gentry.
Tanner Gentry. Down across midfield.
Because if you do that and you put them in, then the incentive for others to schedule these games in the beginning part of the season, non-conference, completely goes away.
Which is what the committee hammers you on all the time. Yep. You're out of conference schedule. Almost sounds like they'd rather a close loss to a high-ranked opponent out of conference.
I get that.
But a win.
But how do you, even though it was razor thin, how do you have, if you have Washington slightly ahead of Michigan last week, and then Washington goes out and puts on the performance that it did to win a conference championship against a really good Colorado team, how do you not keep him at four?
Understood.
Allen throwing it on target to C.J. Johnson. Johnson trying to turn the corner, and he's in on his feet. C.J. Johnson, who scored the game-winning touchdown against San Diego State a couple of weeks ago. He's got the touchdown here.
This offense is the number one offense in the Mountain West Conference because of their explosive plays. San Diego State has been attacking all game, three and a half quarters. They take two plays where they don't try to get after the quarterback, give him time, and they score a touchdown.
And the extra point is good. All of a sudden, it's a field goal game. Consecutive passes of 32 and 43 yards. Take just 42 seconds off the clock. And don't go anywhere, people.
And Rocky Long's thinking, I just cannot allow Josh Allen the time in the pocket. Look at this time. Only rushing four. And you give him that much time with that kind of an arm. They're trying to play a Tampa 2 defense. First time I've seen them, Todd, play that defense tonight, and Allen made him pay.
And we've seen this before. I mean, the first tape I watched was this San Diego State game a couple weeks ago. And after the first two quarters, I was underwhelmed by Josh Allen. Then I watched the second half, and I said, man, this guy's got something. He delivers in second halves of games. He delivers when it's the clutch situation, and it just seems like he relishes this kind of moment.
And the Tampa 2 defense is different from the Buffalo 2 defense, for example. Why don't you explain
well,
to the people?
It's basically like a prevent defense, and so you only rush four, which San Diego State has been bringing five and six and getting after Josh Allen. But they decided to drop Munson, the middle linebacker, deep down the middle of the field, and certainly they didn't get the pressure that Rocky Long wanted. And Allen made him pay.
I prefer the Buffalo 2 defense.
You prefer the Buffalo Wings, is what you.
Here we go. Just over six to play in the Mountain West Championship game. Rashad Penny. He's got two touchdowns on the ground to the far side, down the sideline. Rashad Penny looking to cut it back, and he is stopped. We've been waiting for that return all night long. Rashad Penny, who ran back the opening kickoff for a touchdown on this field 2 weeks ago, gets the big return for 75 yards.
You just can't kick the ball to him and give him a chance to return it. We talked to Rocky Long last night, and he said, our biggest advantage in this game is special teams. Our guys on special teams are better than their guys. Rarely do you get a coach that will say that and admit that. But it's a clear advantage for San Diego State. It hasn't popped up until this crunch time situation here late in the fourth. You see, that's Coach Hawk, the special teams.
Dedicated special teams coach.
Yeah, it's all he does is coach special teams. You don't see that very often anymore, but he has a huge impact on this game.
Special teams player of the year in the conference. Here's the offensive player of the year in the conference, Donnell Pumphrey, the ball carrier. There is a flag on the play.
There's a marker on the field.
See, Humphrey gets up a little bit slow.
Holding, offense number 70, 10-yard penalty, repeat, first down.
That's Arthur Flores, the center. I don't like that call. I understand umpires, they see any defensive lineman go down on the ground and they automatically think it's a hold. I thought that was a good reach block. That's how the center is taught on that play, and just unfortunate for Flores.
Juwan Washington now in the backfield for San Diego State. Chapman was gonna throw, now he tucks it, and now he's gonna be dropped. It's Gaffon who brings him down with a host of brown and gold jerseys. Adnan Burke, what's up? All right, Dandy there. And a great championship game here as well in Laramie, Wyoming. Under five to play, 3-point game. Gaffon has made consecutive big defensive plays. And here's a big offensive play by Penny, who puts his foot in the dirt, turns the corner, and has the first down. On a second and 21.
All right, that's just too easy. Wyoming lost contain quickly on that play. And with a guy like Penny with that kind of speed, you cannot allow him to get to the outside. Logan Wilson loses leverage time.
Yeah, and as a cornerback, you've got to realize that this guy's been doing it all night long. Anytime he's got any kind of angle, he's going to turn the corner because of that burst. So impressed with Penny. 5'11", 220 pounds. I think he's one of the faster backs we've seen in terms of straight line speed all season.
And the leading rusher for the Aztecs tonight is not Donnell Pumphrey. It's Rashad Penny. He's got him by a yard for now. Pitch to Washington. He's dropped for a big loss. It's Gaffon again who's trying to take over this thing. Did the ball come out?
That ball came out.
What a spot for a turnover. And they're going wild here at the war. Gaffon punched it out.
Boy, and you mentioned Donnell Pumphrey on the sideline, Steve, as well as Rashad Penny, and they put in Jawan Washington in crunch time. And you're right, Gaffon here is there, Logan Wilson, and that ball is just not secured well enough by Jawan Washington.
And red zone defense for Wyoming has been the key to their success all season. They give up a ton of yards between the 20s, but in the red zone, they've come up big. They did it several times against San Diego State in the first game, and they're doing it again tonight.
Washington just his second carry of the night. He's a redshirt freshman, and he coughed it up. Gaffon and Wilson poking it free, and Marcus Epps, who is everywhere on that Cowboys defense, came up with a football.
Well, and even though Jawan Washington's a redshirt freshman, it's not like he hadn't carried a whole lot this season. He came in with 50 carries on a year, but still, in a crunch time situation like this in a championship game, you would have loved to have Pumphrey or Penny in the game.
Washington had at least one touchdown in five straight games, but he coughs it up. And here's the ball game for Wyoming. Allen, quick throw to C.J. Johnson. And they'll spot up just shy of the first down, bring up a second down and short. So it's all there for Wyoming, trailing by three with the football.
This team, Wyoming, was 2-10 a year ago, and everybody, I mean everybody, picked them last in the Mountain West Conference this season. For them to be in this position right now, down three with a chance to go down and win the Mountain West Conference Championship, couldn't ask for more.
The pollsters had San Diego State picked first, so they were half right. Here's Allen, down the middle to C.J. Johnson. The ball is out. They're going to say it's an incomplete pass. You can see the official in your screen immediately calling for an incomplete pass.
Wow, another dart from Josh Allen. That ball right on the money. Question is, does he make a football move after securing that football? The ball never gets into his body. So I think they're going to say that was never a catch.
Especially since that's the call on the field, is the incomplete.
Great job by the safety, Malik Smith, the senior, getting his hand on that football.
They're going to look at it before they snap that.
The previous play is under further review. Ruling on the field was an incomplete pass.
What a replay this is going to be. Judson Howard, again, our replay official. I mean, he doesn't bring it to his body, but he's clearly got possession in his two hands and looking to turn upfield.
Yeah, but you have to get that football, control that football, and then make those two football moves.
Yep.
And
no, I understand.
Yeah, you know, that's. Caught that ball 1 foot. Before that second foot even gets down, the ball's out. It was caught, recovered pretty clearly right there by San Diego State, so it would be their football. So Wyoming wants this to be an incomplete pass rather than a complete pass and a fumble. I gotta give some credit to the secondary coaches for San Diego State, because we have seen KZ do this. Now we see Malik Smith. When that ball's in the air, they get their hand up to the point and punch that football out. Cornerbacks coach Tony White, safety coach Danny Gonzalez, both well coached in the secondary. What a great championship game. All these championship games have been great games. They've all been close. You know, this is the fourth Mountain West championship game. Fresno State beat Utah State the first year by 7 points. Boise State beat Fresno the second year. And then last year, San Diego State won by 3 against Air Force. So since the inception of this game, we've had some great matchups.
And this conference gets more competitive every single year. San Diego State was ranked for a long time. fact, were ranked 24th when they came here and lost. That's really all you want is for these contests to live up to the hype.
Yeah, right.
And they were plenty excited about this game. The last December home game for Wyoming. The last December home game for the Cowboys, 1902. All right? Not even your dad was playing. Taking a long time.
It's been a great environment here, too. I mean, the fans have been great. We've been hanging out in Cheyenne and Laramie, and people are lining up to buy the championship gear with the, you know, the brown and gold on it for the Cowboys. And for this to be a rematch of such a great game 2 weeks ago, it's been a lot of fun this week.
And I have some good news. I got an update on my phone. It's going to be 9 degrees warmer tomorrow.
Oh,
so that'll be helpful, McShay. 9 degrees warmer tomorrow.
His bike's frozen again.
Thanks, bud. Yeah, I get about a 10-second delay every time I hit it.
Well, they are taking their time. Got to get it right.
I think he got the microphone caught on his whistle. What's going on there for
Kevin Marr? Talk to me.
After further review, the ruling on the field is confirmed. Incomplete pass.
All that. For an incomplete pass.
The Wyoming fans knew. They were smart. They knew that they needed an incomplete pass, so they kept possession of the ball.
Coming up right after our game, stay tuned for SportsCenter. John Butchergrass and John Anderson. All the highlights from Championship Saturday, Tigers third round, NBA, NHL, college basketball, NFL news, and everything else from a packed Saturday. SportsCenter at night. Following our game, also streaming live on the ESPN app, and watch ESPN. Third down and two after that incomplete pass. And Allen will keep it. Won't get there.
No.
I think he lost a yard on the play.
No, and that was huge for San Diego State. You know, we got caught up in that, you know, instant replay, and that was a huge third and two, and San Diego State sold out to stop the run, and Craig Bohl's going to go for it here. You only have one timeout. You talk about those timeouts, how they come back to bite you. If he had all three, he could have punted.
Clock winding down to 3 minutes left. Fourth and two. Five to snap it. Allen faked the pitch. Wow, not even close. How about this San Diego State defense? Number one of the conference for a reason. And Calvin Munson filling the hole for the Aztecs. They turn it over on downs. And I don't know if Allen's hurt or just frustrated.
It was Munson and Laka Laka. And they have done their homework, San Diego State. Here's Munson, he's going to fill. And here's Laka Laka, he's the one that's going to come. It's a little pitch power here. They studied this in crunch time. Wyoming loved this play. Laka Laka and Munson not fooled and come up with the game winner.
I got to say, I'm a little surprised. You got a quarterback that is red hot throwing the ball. Why, at least one of those two downs, you don't give him a shot to put the ball in the air.
This has been what they've done, Todd, in the Boise State game. They did it in this game 2 weeks ago in crunch time.
But it hasn't worked tonight.
They have run the ball with 17, and I agree with you. That tendency, they continue with it, and Rocky Long and San Diego State were ready for it.
Todd, I'm with you.
Thanks, bud.
Those last two runs go for zero and a loss of two when your quarterback was throwing perfect balls. That's Rashad Penny on the ball carry. And the clock will tick towards 2.5 minutes left in the game. The Mountain West Championship game. Aztecs lead by three. Immediately following our game, tune into ESPN 3 for the 2016 Mountain West Football Championship Trophy Ceremony. Second and nine.
And you see Penny back in the game. Protect the football, that's job number one.
Give it to Penny. He'll pick up about five.
I think Wyoming's going to use their last timeout.
To the 15-yard line. Third and four.
Brings up a third down. And if they hold him to a field goal here, it's still a one-score game.
Yeah, they just they have to.
Tonight's Good Hands play brought to you by Allstate.
Yeah, it's the Jay Henderson fumble that really turned this game around in the middle of the fourth quarter. Putting his hand and ripping that football out, knowing it's a quarterback that probably not as secure with the football as a running back. Put his team in position to win this Mountain West Conference Championship. If they can get a first down here, they can run they can kneel three times and the game's over. If they're not able to get this third and four, I anticipate they kick a field goal and young Josh Allen will have one more chance.
San Diego State's rallying cry all season. It's been win 21. Put a hashtag in front of that. Trying to win their 21st conference title. Would be their second in a row and third in 5 years. Last time they won consecutive conference titles, they have to go back some 42 years.
Good to see Donnell Pumphrey back out on the field. First time since he got nicked and retaped on the sideline.
First down here would end the game. They're not going to get the first down. They're going to lose. Andrew Wingard came up to make the tackle.
Wingard was tracking Pumphrey the entire time. He's been trying to find Pumphrey most of the football game, and he's been embarrassed by Pumphrey at times in the hole, but this time comes up and makes a big stop. Now San Diego State's going to bleed as much time as they can off the clock here.
Should get about a minute 10 left. So they bled the play clock down to one. And San Diego State takes their final timeout. So both teams now out of timeouts. It's a minute 13 left. Well, and the field goal attempt coming up.
But even if San Diego State makes this field goal, yeah, goes up six, with the way that the explosive nature of Wyoming's offense and Josh Allen and Gentry and those guys, that's a lot of time.
No, I agree. But no timeouts. But and it, you know, Todd was talking about, let's let Josh Allen throw the football down the field now. Right.
Well, now you have to.
Right. I mean,
you have to. But the question will be, what does Rocky Long decide to do? Will he pressure him, or will he play that prevent and give him time to throw the football, play zone behind it? That prevent never works.
Right.
As a quarterback, you love to see the prevent. I'm sure that's what Josh Allen would like to
see.
So
why does everybody do it then?
I don't know.
All these brilliant defensive minds.
If I'm Rocky Long, I'm coming after Josh Allen. Because I don't believe that Wyoming has the explosive kind of receivers that I can't play man-to-man coverage against. First things first, looks like San Diego State is going to go for it here, which Rocky Long made the decision to go for two in the previous game 2 weeks ago.
Yes, he did.
Now he's decided to go for it on fourth and four. I would kick the field goal.
Riverboat Gambler.
Force them to score a touchdown.
Here we go. And Chapman with the ball in his hands, going to throw it.
Fumble
the football. Looked like Daniel Brunskill, the right tackle, able to recover.
San Diego State will cover it.
And Chapman comes up limping now. So that was a total disaster in every way for the Aztecs.
I get it. You want to be aggressive. You want to go win a game. But now you put yourself in a difficult situation, because you kick a field goal, you go up six, kick off, and there's maybe a minute and change left. But now this team, they have plenty of time, and all they have to do is go 35 yards to attempt a field goal.
What a time for Wyoming's first sack of the night. No timeouts for the Cowboys.
They're going to blitz them.
Allen feels the pressure, steps up, and shovels it forward. You can hear they're talking about intentional grounding on that. Will be an incomplete pass.
So listen, I didn't agree with the decision by Rocky Long, you know, to go for it there on fourth down, but I completely agree with his decision here to bring pressure and force the issue on Josh Allen. If you're going to make that decision to go for it, then you got to follow it up and be aggressive on defense.
Cooper Roth, Wyoming's kicker, his career long is 46. Now he's a true freshman, so the career hasn't been that long. Hit from 46 tonight, equaling his career high. That gives you an idea of how much yardage they need. Here's Allen throwing, sideline, little back shoulder deal. Look to hook up with Tanner Gentry. Waiting for a flag, doesn't look like it's coming. Ron Smith had the coverage.
Yeah, they identified the matchup on the redshirt freshman Ron Smith. Let's see if he gets a hold of Gentry. Well, I think you could have easily called that pass interference. That right hand locked on the arm of Gentry, got away with it.
The upside for Wyoming only takes a few seconds off the clock, but now it's third and 10 as we're under a minute left. Let's say regulation time. Allen in some trouble. Trying to direct traffic downfield and loosely carrying that football. There is a flag behind the play as Allen got to the 30, and that'll stop the clock with the penalty marker.
This is not going well for Wyoming on offense.
Holding, offense number 61, 10-yard penalty, repeat, third down.
It's Caden Jackson. Trying to hold off that blitz, and yeah, he just gets beat. That's Austin Wyatt there, the linebacker 43 with the effort. Brings it, draws a penalty.
Third and 20. Allen with a good pocket to throw it, and a little communication issue it looked like. C.J. Johnson and Jake Malhart were sort of both in the neighborhood, and Allen split the difference.
And again, you know, I think it's bringing that pressure. Rocky Long has decided to bring that pressure, and it just gets Josh Allen off his rhythm enough that he's been inaccurate. He's been second guessing these throws, and it's been the difference.
So three incompletions and a holding call when all they need is a field goal to tie. Fourth and 20. Allen, as the pocket collapses around him, Kyle Kelly will drop him at the 7. And that should seal the deal.
Another five-man pressure from Rocky Long. He lives by it. This is in their DNA. And this time it's Kyle Kelly. It's been Munson. It's been Barrett. It's been a number of guys. And Rocky Long, you make that decision to go for it on fourth down, trusting. He'll tell you after this game, I guarantee you, when he talks to Todd McShay and Todd asks him, hey, why did you go for it on that fourth down? He's going to say, Todd, because I trusted my defense. We were going to come after them and get the stop we needed to win a championship.
I think he got away with one. That's what I think.
He's going to say, how dare you question my decision making.
Todd, you must ask that question, by the way.
Anything for you, Grease.
And the seconds will tick away.
What a win. What a win for Rocky Long. Back-to-back Mountain West Conference championships. And to do it, coming off of the way they lost to Colorado State, giving up 63 points a week ago. Impressive coming back here and avenging a loss from 2 weeks ago.
And with 80 California kids on the roster playing in these kind of temperatures, they were able to withstand and step up. This is how all championship games should go.
San Diego State 27, the Wyoming Cowboys 24.
San Diego State, they win consecutive conference titles for the first time in 42 years. And also for the first time have now won consecutive seasons of 10 victories as a Division I conference member. Coming up next, stay tuned for SportsCenter. Bucci and John Anderson. And for exclusive live coverage of the Mountain West Football Championship Trophy, join us on ESPN3 in just a few minutes. So long for now from Laramie.
Coach, congratulations. First, I want to ask you, in such an exciting game, the fourth down decision to go for it, I have to believe part of that is just your belief in the defense and it doesn't work out.
Yeah, I thought we were playing well on defense, except for one drive. We give up a touchdown in two plays, but the rest of the night, I thought our defense played really well.
Win 21, that was the motto all year long. How important is this victory and this championship for San Diego State?
Well, all championships are important. I mean, it's special for us. It's special for our players, our fans, our program. And, you know, we haven't played too well the last 2 weeks. It's a great way to go out, and I'll tell you that.
Guys like Donnell Pumphrey and all the seniors, how important was it to get a championship for these guys who have been through the grind 3, 4, 5 years?
Well, they're the guys that showed up when we weren't any good and we said we were going to be pretty good, and they're the ones that helped make it happen. And we've got a pretty good program right now, and I'm glad they went out like this.
Thanks, Coach. Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
Now, clearly emotional. It's a long season, a long career, San Diego State. To finish, you have obviously a bowl game, but to finish with a championship like this, what's it mean to you?
It means the world to me, just to be able to send the seniors out the right way and just to give my all for my guys. It just means the world just to be able to win it for my seniors.
Over 1,100 touches, I should say, throughout your career. How have you been able to do it?
My offensive line, they've been able to block and my fullbacks and the whole offense as a whole, and my offensive coaches, they put me in the right situations to be great.
You told us how kind of amazing it was. You passed so many big names like Tony Dorsett. Well, you passed Ricky Williams tonight. How does that feel?
Well, that's unreal. So that's a Heisman winner, so, I mean, it's great.
Congratulations, man. Go celebrate with your teammates.
Thank you. I appreciate that.
right here. Back to back, baby.
Yes, sir.
Back to back.
Yes, sir.
Back to back.
Yes, sir.
Just us.
Fans, please direct your attention to the field. The post-game awards ceremony and the Mountain West Network's Jesse Kurtz.
Thank you. What a fantastic championship game once again in the Mountain West. It is my honor to introduce the commissioner of the Mountain West, Mr. Craig Thompson, for tonight's trophy presentation. Commissioner.
Thank you, Jesse. I think this is an instant classic for the Mountain West Conference. Congratulations to the University of Wyoming, a tremendous host, and to the two-time defending Mountain West champions, the San Diego State Aztecs.
Bring in the head coach. There we go. Coach Rocky Long, coach, you had mentioned earlier this week you wanted to win the line of scrimmage. You thought that was one place that maybe you didn't in your last trip to Laramie. I think you did that tonight.
Well, I thought both teams played really, really well. I thought that's one of the most exciting games I've been witness to. I wish I wasn't on the sideline. I wish I was up in the stands enjoying it because I didn't enjoy it until we won. But Wyoming gets a lot of credit. They've done a great job. They're a great football team. But I want to tell you what, I'm happy for the Aztecs right here, and we're happy to be champions once again, back-to-back.
You guys go down 10-0, double digits in a hostile environment, no panic. I think that speaks to the veteran group that you have here.
Yeah, well, we have a great group of seniors. They came to our program when we weren't very good, and we told them we were going to be pretty good, and they believed, and they've worked hard this whole time, and they deserve everything they get.
Congratulations, coach.
Thank you.
Let's bring in the defensive MVP, Demonte Casey. Demonte, you've made a living preying on quarterbacks. You get a couple of picks in a very big game, a tough place to play. What was the game plan that you were one step ahead of them?
You know, I owe my team one after I fumbled in the end zone. Hey, I thank my team, my defense, my offense, y'all, my brothers. I love all y'all. I really appreciate y'all.
Because of the way the regular season finished, I know you guys had a point to prove tonight. Did you prove that?
Oh, yes, sir. We did prove that. We proved that. Hey, shout out to Malik.
Malik Jackson had a great championship game last year against Air Force. Congratulations, Demonte Casey, your defensive MVP. And the offensive MVP, Rashad Penny. Rashad, what is it about this city and this track right here that brings out the best in you? A couple of touchdowns and another great return.
I mean, you can't thank the great blocking. I mean, that's where it all starts. So we just executed and just played well.
You talk about that great blocking. Obviously, you're going to have to pound the ground because of the weather here, probably going to complicate things in the pass game. Two 100-yard rushers, yourself and Donnell, that's pretty special in a championship game.
Oh, definitely, when you got the best offensive line in the league. I mean, you can't thank them enough. I love these guys. I mean, I love these guys, man. It's just awesome feeling to get this win.
Rashad Penny, your offensive MVP, the San Diego State Aztecs, the champions of the Mountain West once again. You can watch the press conferences for both teams in about 10 minutes on the Mountain West Network.